NFL kickoff weekend begins next when the Super Bowl champions, the Giants, battle the Redskins. Next, only on NBC.
Manning takes the snap under pressure. Boyd to rush, and he's going to fight out of it. Still fights out of it. Now throws it deep downfield. Wide open Tyree, who makes the catch. Manning will take the snap. Looks left. Pops it left. Throws it wide open. Touchdown, Giants! With 35 seconds to go, and the Giants regain the lead.
In the most astonishing upset in Super Bowl history, the Giants ended New England's bid for a perfect season.
Big move!
The euphoria of that classic was relived earlier today in Midtown Manhattan when Giants legend Harry Carson and Super Bowl hero David Tyree regaled the crowd before escorting the Lombardi Trophy across the Hudson River and into New Jersey, where now 80,000 fans get to join the celebration.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the Lombardi Trophy back to Giants Stadium.
Giants Stadium, you thought I was never coming back, but I had to come back to celebrate an incredible championship season with by far the greatest fans in all of sports. And for one final time, salute my teammates for an incredible championship run. So what I want you to do, I want you to get on your feet. I want you to make some noise. I want you to get ready to stomp somebody out and welcome the New York Giants Super Bowl champions!
With that high draw, welcome to the 2008 National Football League season. Al Michaels and John Madden at the Meadowlands tonight. It's the Giants against the Washington Redskins. The Giants coming off that magical run, unprecedented through the playoffs, defeating the undefeated Patriots in the Super Bowl. Giant fans will be dining out on that baby for a long, long time. John, very infrequently does a Super Bowl champion shock the football world. The Giants did that. Now it's 2008. What do you expect this season?
You know, you can just feel it here. You can feel it in these fans. You can feel it in the players. You know, I go to practice, I talk to the players, and they're so confident now that they know that they're champions. They know that they can go all the way. And I'll tell you, the way Eli Manning is now, you just watch him, and he was good last year, and he was learning the offense, and he knew what to do. But this year, the biggest difference is he is very, very comfortable doing it.
Eli Manning, Super Bowl MVP. Then there are the Washington Redskins, tonight's opponent. 4 years of Joe Gibbs. He leaves with a year left on the contract. Moderate success, 30-34. A couple of playoff appearances, one playoff win. Jim Zorn gets the job, quarterbacks coach of Seattle. First time he's ever been a head coach. He's never called plays before. New coach, new system, the West Coast system. A lot of questions. What gives the Redskins the best chance to beat the Giants tonight, John?
I think what they have to do is run the ball. I'm talking to Jim Zorn last night. He said that their run offense is really ahead of their pass offense. And he said normally he would be 60-40 pass to run. He said it could be the opposite of that tonight, 60 run. run, 40 pass. And I think if the Redskins are going to have a chance tonight, Clinton Portis and Liddell Betts have to have big games running the ball.
Let's go, partner.
Let's go.
The season is underway. Big NFC East matchup as Eli Manning and the world champion Giants take on the Washington Redskins. We break the seal on the 2008 season.
NBC's NFL Kickoff Special is brought to you by the GMC Sierra, the official vehicle of the NFL. Spanish audio provided by Telemundo. Tonight's telecast is presented in high definition by Turbo HD by Dish Network, the only 100% HD service.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on GMC Sierra with better highway fuel efficiency than a Toyota Tundra. And right now, you can get a Sierra 1500 extended cab starting at just $20,488. Offer ends September 30th.
Hello.
Hey, man, how are you? It's me.
Give me a...
Just to say, I spoke to Mom this morning.
All right, cool. Okay.
That's
no,
fine.
No, it's basically...
What are you up to tell me? Yeah,
not really.
07.
Download free ringtones from today's hottest artists. Only at Motorola.com. The Rocker E8, exclusively at T-Mobile.
Hello, Moto.
This is a war. You do what it takes to win.
Traitor, PG-13, now playing.
This salad is really good. You want to buy it?
No, no, thank you. I'm a meatitarian.
A what?
A meatitarian. I only eat meat, beef, bacon. You know, meatitarian.
Oh.
It's a personal choice. You have to commit to it, you know?
The Wendy's Baconator. Six strips of hickory-smoked bacon on 2 quarter-pound patties of fresh, never-frozen beef. It's way better than fast food. It's Wendy's. Have a way better shake way later. Enjoy a hand-spun frosty shake late at night.
NBC Sports, home of Super Bowl 43, welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Early evening, a little after 7 o'clock here in the Big Apple or across the Hudson River from Manhattan in the New Jersey Meadowlands. It's a warm night. The temperature is 87 degrees. And the Giant fans already in full throat as we get set to start the season. They'll get the ball. Sean Sweezum will kick off of the Washington Redskins, who come off a 9-7 season. The Giants were 10-6. It's a good kick. It's taken 4 yards into the end zone by Ahmad Bradshaw. And Bradshaw will get taken down straight on by Mike Sellers, the Washington fullback, up at the 16-yard line. Let's take a look at the Giants starters.
Eli Manning, Ole Miss.
Brandon Jacobs, Southern Illinois.
Madison Hedgecock, North Carolina.
Plexico Burris, Michigan State.
Amani Toomer, Michigan.
Kevin Boss, Western Oregon.
Dave Deal, University of Chief Illinois.
Rich Seibert, Western Illinois.
Sean O'Hara, Rutgers University.
Chris Snee, Boston College.
Coleman McKenzie, Penn State.
And just a note on the other side of the line, the Redskins will start Jason Taylor. Sprained his knee a week and a half ago. They didn't know if he'd be able to play. He's in the game, number 55. And the first play from scrimmage of the season is a 4-yard run to the right side by Brandon Jacobs. Here are the Washington defensive starters.
Jason Taylor, Akron.
Cadiz Griffin, Alabama.
Kendrick Goldston, Georgia.
Andre Carter, University of California.
Rocky McIntosh, the U.
London Fletcher, John Carroll University.
Marcus Washington, Auburn High School.
Carlos Rogers, Auburn University.
Reed Dowdy, Northern Colorado.
LeRon Landry, LSU.
Fred Smoot, Mississippi State.
One guy they're missing is Sean Springs, hurt in practice a couple of days ago, inactive tonight. And the pass intended for Jacobs is incomplete. Trying to set up a screen, the pressure was put on Eli, and it will be third down and 7. And John, a year ago, a lot of questions about the Giants. Would Tom Coughlin survive? How would they replace Tiki Barber? And will Eli Manning ever deliver? I think he had.
Oh, yeah. And remember last year it was, well, he doesn't have the personality. He's quiet. You know, he doesn't give speeches and stuff. And now, a year later, after he wins the Super Bowl, he's a Super Bowl MVP. He's the quiet leader. He's the humble quarterback. He was the same thing a year ago.
Can he be the guy? Case closed. 3rd and 7 from the 19-yard line. Manning fires over the middle, and they're going to convert because Steve Smith, who made some big catches in the Super Bowl on 3rd down plays, does it here. He's tackled there by London Fletcher. In the Super Bowl, he had 4 3rd down conversions.
Well, here he is. He's an inside receiver, and that's what they like to do, is put him in the slot and let him work the middle. Remember when they lost Jeremy Shockey and they talked about him and said that, you know, that they're going to miss him in the passing game? Steve Smith kind of took his place in the passing game.
Kevin Walsh, the tight end in motion. Jeremy Shockey is gone, sent from New Orleans. Here goes Jacobs, tough runner. Jacobs up to the 31-yard line. When the Redskins lost Philip Daniels, their starting defensive left end, in training camp, they went out and got Jason Taylor, and there was some speculation as to whether he would or wouldn't play in Miami. So right off the bat, Vinny Serrato, who runs the football operation, and the owner, Dan Snyder, went out and picked up a guy who's made 130 consecutive starts. Sprained his knee a couple of weeks ago, but starting tonight.
Right, and the Giants are testing him right off the bat. If you've noticed that every time they've run the ball so far, they've run it right at Jason Taylor.
2nd and 7. Humphrey going deep, wide open. Plaxico Burress, who scored the winning touchdown in the Super Bowl. So the corner bites on the fake down the right sideline, and getting free is Burress, who was not healthy at all last year, still had a great year, healthier this year despite missing a lot of training.
Yeah, if they're going to go deep, you know it's going to be the Plaxico Burress. And you see Carlos Rogers over there, he's looking to the inside, and Plaxico Burress runs right by him. Now, LaRon Landry is a free safety, and he can usually go sideline to sideline. He gets there just a step late on Burris's catch.
Rogers gets burned. It's a 30-yard gain. The ball is at the 40-yard line on 1st down. Manning, before he gets hit, fires to the 21, and that's Burris again. Knee and ankle injuries last year. He hardly practiced at all. Didn't practice very much in training camp, but has had full practices over the past week and catches passes back to back. That's for 19.
I think they found a matchup they like out there on the right side. Although you can see Eli Manning look to the left before he came back to Plaxico Burress, who was running an in on Carlos Rogers. The play before, he went up on Rogers, and then he gets Rogers playing off, worried about that. Then he runs in or a dig route.
Now to the left side goes Jacobs, and Jacobs takes it to the 17. The Giants by committee, replacing Barber last year. Jacobs was their main man, gained over 1,000 yards. He missed 4 or 5 games with injuries. Derek Ward was also very effective. He missed some time with injuries. And then the emergence of Ahmad Bradshaw, who was great in particular in postseason.
You know, and then there's a lot of constants. I mean, they have the same starting offense that they had last year. But this offensive line is super. They are a great, great unit. And they're very, very good at run blocking.
All 5 of those guys started all 16 games during last year's regular season. Manning gets hit as he throws. The pass is incomplete. And then Jacobs with a little head slap back and forth there with the linebacker, Marcus Washington. And let's check in with Andrea Kramer. Andrea.
Thank you, Al. Well, we saw the 2 big catches by Plaxico Burress, and he told me it's the best he's felt in nearly 2 years, ready to get the big play back in the Giants offense. But he's also especially motivated because finally, after 7 months of negotiation, he had a new contract signed today. They had 3 years remaining, so it's now a 5-year $35 million deal, $11 million guaranteed and payable this year. And interestingly, guys, Barris said he really wanted to get that security after watching teammate O.C. Yermanura lost for the season with an injury. He's thrilled he'll end his career as a Giant.
Two catches on this run. Meanwhile, here's Kedrick Golson, who won the starting left tackle job. Anthony Montgomery had started last year. The two were battling. Montgomery wasn't completely healthy. And there is Montgomery, who had lost his starting job, even though he was going to be rotated in, and now he'll probably have to play a lot more as Golston comes limping off.
Yeah, that's one thing about that Redskin defensive line. They, you know, they have starters, but they all play a lot. They just keep a constant rotation.
Third and six. Ed Hockley is the referee. There's no flag on the last play, but he may just want to settle things down here as he had Jacobs and Washington going at it early. A lot of join. And Ed is, as we all know, about as take charge as any ref in the
right.
league.
Right, he's a referee anything. I mean, a fight could break out, he'd be a fight referee. Giants are in 3-by-1 now. 3 on the right side, 1 receiver on the left side.
From the gun, 3rd and 6. Manning under pressure, gets it away, it's juggled, it's bobbled, and it's caught!
That is a heck of a throw by Eli Manning, because he was hit just as he threw it.
By Reed Dowdy on a safety blitz.
But you talk about a quarterback having to stand in there, a quarterback having to be tough. Watch Eli here. Here comes a free rusher. He moves a little to his right, moves up, and then throws a perfect strike. These are the types of things that you don't coach. They're an instinct that a quarterback has of getting away from a free rusher. Some of them never learn it.
Well, they ended the season, of course, with a lot of magic, and there's a little mini magic here on the first drive. There is Archie, and he'll be making his way, along with his wife Olivia, over to Indianapolis, and Eli's wife Abby, he got married over the summer. They give the ball on the fake to Jacobs, and then it's thrown out of the back of the end zone, intended for Kevin Boss. Good play fake, and Kevin Boss, who is the starting tight end now that Jeremy Shockey has been dealt to New Orleans and had a good postseason, of course, is going to see a lot of action this year, second year out of Western Oregon.
Right, and I think if you say where they're going to miss Jeremy Shockey, it's in the blocking area. Kevin Boss is a pretty good receiver. You know, he's a big target, he's all those things, but he's really not a good blocker. In fact, because he's so tall, he doesn't have a lot of knee bend. I think that's why he's not a real good blocker.
6'6", 253. This is the 11th play of the opening drive. Ross lines up on the left. And to the back of the end zone goes the pass, and there's a flag because Amani Toomer was interfered with by Fred Smoot. But they'll get together, the officials will, the side judge and the head linesman, to discuss it.
Fred Smoot is saying it was offensive interference.
Here comes Ed Hockley to mediate, or at least absorb the information.
I think Fred Smoot telling you right now what it is. He heard it.
The pass was incomplete. Pass interference, defense, number 27. The ball is placed at the 1 yard line, first down.
Yeah, you know, Fred Smoot heard that when he started shaking his head. Here's a route here. Here's Fred Smoot on Amani Toomer. He gives him an out move. Yeah, he did push him. He did have contact before the ball got there while the ball was in the air. That's pass interference. I know what Fred Smoot is saying, that I did push him, I did run into him, but he also pushed me.
Only good news to the Redskins on this drive right now is Golston is back in the game. He came limping off. Back end at defensive tackle. 5 minutes into the game, it's first and goal. The fake to Jacobs. Manning on a roll. Manning looking for the end zone. He's in there. Touchdown. Well, these fans couldn't wait for the Giants to get home because they did it all on the road last year. It was worth waiting for.
Right, and they started right off offensively where they left off. Here's a bootleg. They get that power running game going. They fake it to the left, and Eli keeps it and goes out to the right. Watch Jason Taylor. He gets caught to the inside. Once he gets caught there, Eli is going to outrun him.
44-year-old John Carney signed this week to kick the extra point, and it's good. The hold by 42-year-old Jeff Fegels. There's Kevin Gilbride, the offensive coordinator. Great drive. 11 plays, 84 yards, and the Super Bowl champs look just like the Super Bowl champs.
Welcome to Southwest Airlines.
Thanks. I need to check this bag. How much is that going to cost me?
There's no charge on Southwest, sir.
Hallelujah!
Well, I have another one, and I'm sure I'll have to pay for that.
Actually, your first two check bags are free.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
On Southwest Airlines, we don't believe in charging for things that should be free. So what you see is what you pay. Low fares, no hidden fees.
It has 124 sound-dampening innovations that help make the cabin as quiet as the flagship BMW and Mercedes sedans, which helps keep outside noises, well, outside. Introducing the new Hyundai Genesis. Find out more at HyundaiGenesis.com.
We need to open this Coors Light cooler for some frost-brew refreshment. Do you know the combination?
Go double right, turbo right, double pump.
The coach, it's not working.
Tandem right, Z-Peel, where's San Diego?
Forget it, coach. I'm gonna wedge it open with a crowbar.
Let's wedge it.
I'm trying.
Frost-brewed Coors Light, official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Coach, we still can't get into the Coors Light. You're gonna have to come up here.
Time out. He's coming.
This NFL kickoff special is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Low fares, no hidden fees. By the new Hyundai Genesis. It all starts with this. By Sprint, get NFL Mobile Live only on the Now Network. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Tonight's aerial coverage brought to you by Gillette Body Wash. Sunset over Manhattan and now to Giants Stadium, and you can see just above the stadium the new stadium under construction. The Giants will play here this year and next year, and then the Giants and the Jets move across the parking lot. So now John Cartwright will get spun down in front of his bench at the 27-yard line by Dominic Hixon. So Jim Zorn's Redskins have the ball for the first time this season when we come back.
Kick. A 30-yard field goal attempt to try to win it. Ball down. Kick on the way. It is good. It's good. It's good. And that's it.
Live from your pocket, it's the NFL. Get the new NFL Mobile Live free with any data plan. Only from Sprint. Only on the Now Network.
The new 375-horsepower Hyundai Genesis has a more effective braking performance than the BMW 550i. So you can avoid the obstacles you expect. It also has extraordinary safety features. So you can deal with the ones you don't. Find out more at HyundaiGenesis.com.
It happens to every guy. While you sleep, your skin dehydrates. Prepare to defeat dry skin with new Gillette Dry Skin Hydrator and Body Wash. It combines a deep cleaning body wash with three times the hydrators for a powerful defense against dry skin. You'll step out of the shower feeling like you can take on the world. New Gillette 2-in-1 Dry Skin Hydrator and Body Wash. Unleash the power of your shower.
Thank you, New York!
Pick
your favorite numbers and play Numbers and Win 4 from the New York Lottery. So what numbers do you want to hear today? Knight Rider, the movie, was a hit. Now it's a new series with more action and more muscle. Knight Rider premieres Wednesday, September 24th, right here on NBC. Up there at the East River, the Brooklyn Bridge. And now back to Jersey, we come to the 27-yard line where Jason Campbell is the Washington quarterback. And he'll start with a short drop. He's flushed out of the pocket and he gets sacked by a team that led the league in sacks last year with 53. And that's Justin Tuck, who emerged last year in the shadow of Umanura and Strahan and really came into his own. And that's the way his season begins.
You know, and you talk about, you know, the pressure and the pressure inside. Justin Tuck is the guy that gives you that. He takes an inside move, and you just look at Jason Campbell. He holds the ball too long. You take a three-step drop, and in this offense, it has to be 1, 2, 3. Boom! The ball has to be out of there. If you go 1, 2, 3 and stand there, it's going to be a sack.
Now Portis. A couple. He went right over to Stephon Heyer, the new starter at right tackle. Let's take a look at that Redskin offense.
Jason Campbell, Auburn.
Clint Portis, the U. Mike Sellers, North Person High School.
Santana Moss, the U.
Antoine Randall, Indiana University.
Chris Cooley, Utah State.
Chris Samuels, Alabama.
Pete Kendall, Boston College.
Casey Raubach, Wisconsin.
Brandon Thomas, Mississippi State.
Stephon Heyer, University of Maryland.
Third and 15 with split backs here. Giants showing blitz. Flag is down before the snap. So Ed Hockley will make his first call of the night.
Ball start. Offense, number 74. 5-yard penalty, it's third down.
John Jansen has been the rock of that line, but he lost his starting job to Heyer now in his second year. So Heyer gets beat for the sack, and now he has a false start.
And this isn't the way Jim Zorn envisioned this offense to start in their first regular season game. But, you know, you're playing the Giants here, this crowd fired up, this defense is really a lot better than the offense. And I'm surprised that they just didn't start off just handing the ball off a little. You start off with a sack, and then the rest of the series is going to be uphill.
And again, out of split backs, they give the ball to Portis, who takes it to the 22-yard line. So the Giants march down the field, 84 yards. Then the Redskins go three and out. The Giants throw a sack in there. And now a rookie punter comes in. This is Durant Brooks. He was the only punter who was drafted last April, sixth round out of Georgia Tech. He was in a battle with Derek Frost right up until the end last week. We did the game against Jacksonville. It looked like Frost had the better night, but they decided to go with Brooks for the future. And his first NFL kick is a fairly short one, collected at the 44-yard line by R.W. McQuarters. The coverage initially is good, but then McQuarters is able to take it back up to the 48-yard line and set the Giants up just shy of midfield. Halfway through the opening quarter, 7-0 New York.
Coach Billick, the silver ticket promotion is back. Drink cold, refreshing Coors Light, and you could win NFL tickets.
Very good, I like that.
Hey, Coach, I've got a lucky horseshoe.
And I've got a leprechaun.
If you combine the two, then you're talking about between a 95 and 98% chance of winning.
Look for the official entry code inside special packs of Coors Light for your chance to win NFL tickets.
Coach, can the leprechaun refresh his buddies with your Coors Light?
As long as they act like men, I will treat them like men.
Hey, Coach.
The all-new 375-horsepower Hyundai Genesis can pull 0.94 Gs through a corner, surprisingly better than the BMW 550i, which means the competition may just begin to fall out of the picture. Find out more at HyundaiGenesis.com.
You're the folks that bought the old Miller place, in spite of what happened there.
Excuse me?
It's a dead zone. Calls have been getting lost in there for years. The last residents went completely insane.
We have the Verizon network.
You're good.
Well, you've got crabgrass.
We test our network every day to be America's most reliable, Verizon Wireless. Get the BlackBerry Pearl or the exclusive pink BlackBerry Curve, now just $99.99.
Thursday, September 25th, Earl's tackling the biggest stuff on his list.
results will vary.
I need a hug.
Girls back September 25th on NBC.
Tom Coughlin coached the Jacksonville Jaguars for 9 years. Left there, spent a year out of the NFL, and then came back to coach the Giants in 04. Wins the Super Bowl now in his fifth year in a brand new contract. From the 48-yard line, they sent Jacobs over the right side. Tough to bring down. 7-yard gain for Jacobs, who is 6'4 and 264.
Yeah, I think you can see the game plan right off the bat is when they run, they want to run right, and they want to run right at Jason Taylor because, you know, he's not a big guy, and he's not a run player anyway. If you can get strong side to his side, and he has a bad knee, you can see that he just can't hold the point on that side. And that's going to be a problem all night.
Jacobs last year averaged 5 yards per carry.
See, here's where Eli's a lot more comfortable doing these kinds of things.
And looks the part, too. And swings it out to Jacobs, who juggles it and can't get the handle, and that pass is complete. It'll be 3rd down and 3. Fred Smoot put the pressure on from the corner. You'll see Eli's brother, Peyton, who didn't play at all in preseason because of the infected bursa sac, had that removed when Indianapolis opens up its season on Sunday Night Football as we head from here to Indy, and the Chicago Bears will be coming into town.
And here we go, 3rd down, and they go 3 wide receivers, and you can see
right here.
Steve Smith now is up on the right, and they usually, Eli Manning really likes Steve Smith on 3rd down situations.
But Manning didn't like what he saw from the defense and the play call there. Timeout, New York.
The new 375-horsepower Hyundai Genesis can go from 0 to 60 in 5.7 seconds, even faster than a Porsche Boxster. Which means, if it starts now, it will reach 60 miles an hour now. Find out more at HyundaiGenesis.com.
Morning, Mr. Bill. Here you go.
Thanks, Mr. Hans.
Coffee, $2 on debit MasterCard.
I always wanted brown shoes.
Your personal trainer says to step it up a notch.
Gym membership, $59 a month.
Good, there's a bike open. What a day.
Briefcase, $120.
Time to pack up, Mr. Bill.
Oh, no!
Making it through the day.
Hey, the bus is right on schedule.
Priceless. For whatever comes your way, there's debit MasterCard.
This salad is really good. You want a bite?
No, thank you. I'm a meatitarian.
A what?
A meatitarian. I only eat meat, beef, bacon. You know, meatitarian.
Oh.
It's a personal choice. You have to commit to it, you know?
The Wendy's Baconator. Six strips of hickory-smoked bacon on two quarter-pound patties of fresh, never-frozen beef. It's way better than fast food. It's Wendy's. Have a way better shake way later. Enjoy a hand-spun frosty shake late at night.
Monday, from the creator of Deadliest Catch, comes TV's toughest competition.
This creek has claimed quite a few people.
This is the hardest thing I've ever done.
All new America's Toughest Jobs, Monday on NBC.
You can experience tonight's game in Sunday Night Football on NBCSports.com and NFL.com. It's called Sunday Night Football Extra. You can see the game, replay stats, even choose your own camera angles. You don't like the announcers? Too bad, you're stuck with us. But apart from that, check it out. 3rd and 3. Here is Derek Ward taking the shovel to the outside, breaking a London Fletcher tackle and picking up the first down after the timeout.
I knew that play was going to go to Derek Ward because when they took the timeout, Brandon Jacobs was trying to get out, and this play was called for Derek Ward. So they put him in there, but before the timeout, they had Jacobs in there. And you know, a lot of teams have these, you know, these packages and these kinds of things, and that was Derek Ward's play. And you can see where, again, they're running right at Jason Taylor.
Now they spread it out, 5 wide, including Jacobs set to the right side. at a wide receiver spot, and the pass will go to Plaxico Burress, and he is a little short of the first down. He gets taken down by the safety, LaRon Landry, who, because of a hamstring problem, did not play at all in training camp, but told us last night he's 97%.
You know, don't you just feel, here's Plaxico Burress right here, and he's going to come up and just run a hook, find a hole right in there, get to the inside, work back to the quarterback, and you just feel that they can throw in front of these corners, in front of these Redskin defensive backs all night.
And one of them that's missing, of course, is Sean Spring. So the Redskins are short in that area.
Last night they thought Sean Spring was not only going to play, but he was going to start.
He came out before the game and they said no. Meanwhile, Jacobs says, no, you're not going to stop me. And the big bull goes down to the 14-yard line. He runs right over Landry for a 17-yard carry.
You know, and you're not going to see a lot of that. But, you know, here they run to the left. They get a pretty good lead, a good cutback. Now watch him unload right there on Landry. That is getting run over. Landry's going to say, where in the heck did that truck come from?
Landry just went from the 97% he told us he was last night to about 84.
Landry's about not knowing where the heck he is right now.
Four and a half to go, quarter. Off the fake. Manning gets chased, and Manning will throw that one away. Chased that time by Kedrick Golston, who was hurt on the first series, but came back into the game. Second down and 10 for the Giants. And there is Landry, and we talked about the fact he didn't play at all in preseason, didn't practice that much either because of the hamstring, and then he was run over by Jacobs, and Chris Horton, a seventh round draft choice out of UCLA, a rookie, will fill that role.
Yeah, Brandon Jacobs really unloads on him. Watch him, I mean, he takes LaRon Landry and shakes his whole body.
Well, Landry gives away 62 pounds to Jacobs. And here he goes again. Boom, down to the 6-yard line. London Fletcher.
Did I just hear a boom?
I had to throw it in. We've been working together for, this is our seventh year. You know, when I see Brandon Jacobs, it's the only way to describe it.
I know, and you think of that. And I mean, here's a 265-pound tailback, and we're talking to Greg Blash last night, the defense coordinator of the Redskins, and he said, I told all my defensive backs, you better get them lower. You're going to be on a highlight reel. LaRon Landry didn't listen to that part of the speech.
You're not going to get me for copyright infringement, are you?
Anyone going to have booms.
Third and one.
Just throw it out there.
Here's Derek Ward in the game now. And Ward probes the right side but can't get the first. London Fletcher, how good is this guy and how consistent is he? Last year, all season long, he missed a total of 10 plays from scrimmage. 10 of the thousands, more than 1,000 plays that are run against the defense, 1,026 total plays, he missed 10 of them.
Right, and that could have been a 4-point tackle right there, because by stopping the Giants here and causing fourth down, it sent him into a field goal situation. So you look at some plays and you can put points on them. That was a 4-point tackle by London Fletcher.
Now a 24-yard attempt. Carney, a long time with San Diego and with New Orleans, last year with Jacksonville and Kansas City. Now, at least for the moment, with the Giants, puts it through. So he has scored 4 points tonight. The Giants have a total of 10. 10-0 Giants, 2:53 left in the quarter.
It's a big moment in a boy's life. It's a rite of passage, really. When you can look him in the eye, and you know that he's ready.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Time to grab manhood by the horns. The NFL. That's how I see it.
The new Samsung Series 8. Now until September 27th, get $200 off any NFL collectible when you buy select Samsung HD TVs.
What do people think of pasta from Pizza Hut?
That's good.
This is delicious.
They can't get enough of Toscani pastas from Pizza Hut. Choose from new premium bacon mac and cheese, meat marinara, or creamy chicken Alfredo. 3 pounds delivered with breadsticks for $12.99. Now get pasta from Pizza Hut.
Somebody shot another bad guy.
Give him a medal.
These bodies are drifting in your direction.
Drifting or being pushed?
Whatever happens, I'm not taking it down with me.
If you don't back off, you will regret it.
Righteous Kill. Rated R. September 12th.
Notre Dame Saturday returns to NBC, and the Irish are fighting for a return to the nation's elite. The season opens versus San Diego State Saturday, and a week later against Michigan. Notre Dame Saturday on NBC.
We got to try to match their intensity. We got to come out, you know, and take the crowd out of it early, and we got to play together.
You know it's going to be a 15-round fight, so I think that the physical battle is really going to be paramount.
Our goal and our only purpose here is to win.
Well, right now the New York Giants on top 10-0, 2:53 left in the quarter. You know, John, the Giants are the Super Bowl champions, but in a way, people are saying, well, Dallas is better than they are, and maybe a couple of other teams, and in the AFC, so maybe they're fueled a little bit by that. Brett Favre, of course, comes to town. He plays in the same stadium, so he took a little bit of the spotlight away. And the Giants are making a pretty good opening statement tonight about, hey, you know what, we're the champs.
Yeah, and I think that's true, and that's the way it should be. I mean, I believe you earn a championship, and when you're the champion, you're the champion until someone beats you. So maybe Dallas.
Football field at the 3-yard line. This is Locke Cartwright taking it up to the 24. And let's take a look at the Giant defense.
Justin Tuck, Notre Dame.
Barry Colfield, Northwestern.
Fred Roberts, Wake Forest.
Matthias Kiwanuka, Boston College.
Jarris Wilkinson, Georgia Tech.
AP, Arizona.
Danny Clark, Illinois.
Aaron Ross, Lee, University of Texas.
James Butler, Georgia Tech.
Mike Johnson, Arizona.
Corey Webster, LSU.
Corey Webster with a big interception in the NFC Championship game against the Packers last year, and we've got a whistle before the play again, and we've got a false start. The second one against Washington.
False start, offense number 82. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Antoine Randall-L, the wide receiver.
Yeah, the Giant defense is, it's a pressure defense anyway, and it's a blitzing defense, and you always kind of assume, you know, long yardage, you're going to blitz, third and long, those types of things. But the Giants also will run blitz and blitz on first down, as they did on that play, bringing the middle linebacker Antonio Pierce.
Again, they go with split backs. Porter stays in the block, and that's volleyball back by Danny Clark. He's one of the new Giants. They picked him up as a free agent from the Texans. He's been around ninth year in the league, played for Tom Coughlin back at Jacksonville.
Yeah, we just talked about the blitz, and this is what the Giants do. Clark comes from right here. He's unblocked. He knows that you just key the quarterback. You're trying to get to him. But when he sets to throw, you go up and knock it down. And Steve Spagnuolo is the defensive coordinator of the Giants. Almost became the head coach of the Redskins last year, but he loves to blitz. And he says, as long as it works, I'll keep doing it all night.
On second and 15, they run a draw. Portis tackled by Butler. Spagnuolo worked under Jim Johnson, the great defensive coordinator at Philadelphia. Gets the job here. So how does it start out for them? They give up 80 points in the first two games. They look awful. They're 0-2. They did 17-3 to Washington at halftime of the third game. Win that game, thanks mainly to a goal line stand. The next thing you know, he's in demand and could have had the Redskin head coaching job, but opted to stay in New York.
And then he's going to get more offers, and he knows that, and Tom Coughlin knows that, and he's playing his dime defense now.
On third and 12, they spread it out, and Santana Moss was the intended receiver, but it looked like there were 37 blue shirts in coverage. Fourth down.
Yeah, that was a very good mixture of defense. He gave him on first down, he gave him a blitz. Second down, he gave him a blitz. Third down, he gave him six defensive backs and made him throw into that. So far, early in this game, the Giant defense really has the Redskin offense on their heels, to say the least.
Brooks to punt. McQuarters to run it back. And he just does get that one away. Decent distance. Flag is down. McQuarters gets taken down at the 42, but Hockley throws the flag back at the 10-yard line because Jerome McDougal came in and made contact with the punter.
The kicker, defense number 95, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, that's Justin McDougal's or Jerome McDougal's Giants debut. He was with the Eagles. They picked them up last week, and here he cost them possession.
That wasn't bad. I mean, it was just one of those things that you always talk about, going to a point 5 yards in front of the punter, not going to the punter. McDougal was about 2 or 3 yards in front of the punter. He was a little tight. But that was a big break there for the Redskins, because, like I said, it's not only a 15-yard penalty, but it's an automatic first down. And maybe for the first time here, it gives them pretty good field position.
And that's the Skins' first down of the game. The game in which the Giants have gained 124 yards, and Washington has gained 3 from the 37-yard line. Portis slips, but slithers to the outside, and then pays the price up at the 41-yard line. John, talking about Clinton Portis being such a big factor, he led the league in carries last year, and he's going to take himself out of the game here for at least a play. But he had a big night here last December, but he might have gotten poked in the eye.
And Clinton Portis is a real tough guy. I mean, and I think that if the Redskins early in the season are going to have much success offensively, I think he has to be a pretty big part of it. And you know, the Redskins are using the same Joe Gibbs running game.
Here's Liddell Betts, who was his backup. Betts has been around. He was their second round choice in 02 out of the University of Iowa. Kiwanuka making the tackle. Kiwanuka going from linebacker back to end when Umanura was out for the season.
You know, and he feels pretty comfortable in doing that too. I mean, he's just reading the line. You know, the line's coming down, you know, to cut. He just goes right down with that offensive line, and it brings him right into the running back. I think Kiwanuka playing that right end is not going to be a problem for the Giants. And I think Justin Tuck, obviously, playing the left end will not be a problem either.
Third down and 7 now. Campbell was under pressure again that time. Aaron Ross, the corner, came in, forced the issue. And apart from that penalty, the Redskins still don't have a first down. Campbell has started the night 0 for his first 3. Manning 5 for 10 for 76.
Remember how they used to last year? They would move Justin Tuck around, and you thought maybe he's playing left end now. They're not going to do it. Well, they can still do it. They put someone else at left end, McDougal at left end, and then let him play like Tuck played last year.
Brooks already with his third punt, a short punt, and it's fair caught at the 31-yard line by McQuarters, and we go to Andrea.
Well, guys, you were talking about Steve Spagnuolo. Now, he spent almost 24 hours interviewing for the Redskin job at the home of owner Dan Snyder, along with Vinny Serrato, the vice president. Now, Spagnuolo told me he was flattered and overwhelmed by it, but that it was a gut decision that he pulled his name out of consideration. However, Serrato told me not only did they never offer Spagnuolo the job, he said that when they reviewed the candidates, they felt that he was not the right person and that they did not have the comfort level with Spagnuolo.
Well, you never know when something is revisionist history or not. But we'll just take that at face value. From the 32-yard line, first down. Off the play fake, the pass is incomplete. One thing that we do know is that when they interviewed Spagnuolo, Jim Zorn had already gone to Washington. They hired Zorn as the offensive coordinator. So no matter who the head coach was going to be, Zorn was going to be the offensive coordinator. For a while, it looked like it would be Jim Fossil. Steve Mariucci, I guess, was in the mix for a while. A couple of other guys were in the mix. We talked about Spagnuolo. And then finally, in early February, they interviewed Zorn for the head coaching job. So he got the big raise and the big promotion to offensive coordinator. Then he's the big guy.
Right, and I think they not only had the offensive coordinator hired, but I think they had Greg Blosch, the defensive coordinator, hired.
This is Derek Ward up to the 42-yard line, and that will take us to the end of the first quarter, a most productive one for the Super Bowl champs. The Giants lead the Redskins by a score of 10 to nothing in NBC's NFL Kickoff Special. We'll continue right after these messages.
You really accomplished something.
Thank you, Mr. President.
This fall,
color folk be looking up to you. You owe them more than just running a ball.
Universal Pictures presents,
this is not just a game anymore.
A story about how far you can go.
We shouldn't play him.
I'm playing.
You're damn right you are.
When you let nothing stand in your way. Inspired by the true story. The Express, rated PG, in theaters October 10th.
Hi, I'm Tony Romo.
I've agreed to have myself doubled in size so that you never forget that new lemon-flavored Pepsi NFL kickoff gives you double Pepsi stuff points.
With double stuff points, you can earn lots of cool stuff twice as fast, like MP3s, electronics, and even chances to win free trips.
Because double really is better.
Also available in diet.
For a limited time, get double stuff points when you drink lemon-flavored Pepsi NFL kickoff and earn lots of cool stuff twice as fast.
Third and five for the Browns.
Hey, what's the score?
Broncos up by three.
But Browns about to score, baby.
Yo, who's winning the game?
When all you want is the Thursday night special.
Play fake, Romo deep to the middle.
When you want to hear the game, but you're out on the range.
Yeah. How about them Cowboys?
When all you want is to never miss a highlight.
Second touchdown of the night.
When all you want is football.
Every day is like Sunday.
Not shaken, just nerd. Chuck premieres Monday, September 29th on NBC.
August 20th, the passing of Gene Upshaw, who was so instrumental in so many ways in the history of the National Football League as the Raiders guard for 15 seasons. To the Hall of Fame he went, and then to run the NFL Players Association. His widow Terry and his three sons here before the game, and Terry tossing the coin to start the 2008 season. Throughout the course of the season, the players are going to wear patches. There it is, GU63. And for the opening weekend games, we have the logo, the emblem is on the field. And John, you were down in Washington last week and were very instrumental in the service. It must have been quite something.
Yeah, it was. I mean, I was so close to Gene over the years. We both started the same year with the Oakland Raiders in 1967. So we were together directly and indirectly for 41 years. And when he gave, I mean, he gave himself to pro football. I mean, that's, you know, as a player, I mean, he was a great player. He was a Hall of Famer, and then he went on for 25 years to lead the union. And you think of what the players were when he started 25 years ago, and what they were making and where they are today and what they're making. And Gene Upshaw was maybe the largest contributor to pro football ever.
You know, I'm not going to dispute that. I just think that, you know, we talked about this last week. The thing I loved about him, you ask him a question, you got a direct answer.
He didn't
work the edges.
Yeah.
He went right up the middle with it.
Right, and it may not always be the answer you want.
On second down and 10, after the pass for Toomer was incomplete, on second down they give the ball to Derek Ward in his fifth year, former Jet, who came into his own last year, and then he got hurt, but he was part of that committee that was so successful in getting the Giants to the playoffs, and then he was hurt at the end.
And now look at the committee they have. I mean, they start Brandon Jacobs, who can run over anything, and then they can bring Derek Ward, and they still have Ahmad Bradshaw as a change of pace. So just in their running game alone, they could throw so many things at you. But again, I go back, it all starts with this group right here, that offensive line that I think is one of the best in football.
Third and seven, and that line does its job long enough for Manning to get the pass off, and it's caught by Sonoris Moss, who gets taken down at the 33-yard line. So Moss, for a 23-yard gain, he would be their number four wide receiver, his first catch of the season.
You know, if I were an offensive lineman, though, I would want to protect for Eli Manning, because I know he's going to hang in there, and someone may get off my block, just like they did on David Deal that time, but he's going to hang in there and still make that throw. Sonoris Moss does a good job of selling that he's going to go deep before he breaks the outlaw.
Well, first down, now they give the ball to Ward. I don't know what the odds were on the proposition, but Sonoris is Santana's brother, younger brother. Santana, the number one receiver for the Washington Redskins, and you would have thought that Santana would have caught a pass this season before Sonoris. There is Santana Moss.
And we were talking about the depth that they have a running back, the Giants, but also a wide receiver. When you look at Burris, and then they got Dominic Hickson and Monty Toomer, Steve Smith, Sonoris Moss. I mean, they can bring a lot of guys at you, and they are doing it in this first half.
Now, I didn't even mention the Super Bowl hero, David Tyree, who had knee surgery in the offseason. They do hope to have him back before the season ends, and Manning's going to have to call the Giants' second time out of the half. When we come back, it'll be second down and six. Chinch up 10-0.
Look, the mountains on this Coors Light cold-activated bottle turn blue and the beer is cold. How can you tell your beer is cold without it?
I can't do it. You know, I just can't do it.
Coach, when was the first time you saw the mountains turn blue?
91, when we won the division.
It wasn't invented yet.
When the mountains turn blue, beer is cold and ready for kickoff.
Please not if you like the following. A taste as cold as the Rockies. Mm-hmm. Cold-activated bottles. Mm-hmm. Shirts with random triangles. Mm-hmm.
Touch it, bring it, bathe, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, all that is. Yeah. Feel it, curl it, find it, view it, code it, jump and yeah. Pump it. Yeah. Technologic. Yeah. Technologic. Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, crash it, change it, upgrade it, charge it, hard it, use it, press it, snap it, work it, erase it. Yeah. Yeah. Bathe, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, all that is. Technology.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hey.
What's on your playlist?
Oh. Alanis Morissette, Underneath, Green Day, American Idiot, Mariah Carey, Bye Bye. Oh, We Belong Together. Sean Paul, Get Busy, ZZ Top, Sharp Dressed Man.
Introducing VCast Music with Rhapsody.
Tush.
Unlimited access to millions of songs for your computer and phone for one low monthly fee. From top artists to hidden gems, love them or hate them, you get them all. Exclusively from America's most entertaining network, Verizon Wireless.
We talked about David Tyree, offseason surgery, so still unable to play. But this one is for the time capsule, folks. We'll see you for the rest of your lives, your kids' lives, your grandkids' lives. They'll play it over and over. Maybe the most dramatic play ever in a Super Bowl. Manning almost in the grasp. Mike Carey almost blew the whistle. Back to throw. Pins it against his helmet. Falls down on top of Rodney Harrison. That sets up the Burris catch. It will live forever. Second down and six now with the ball at the 28-yard line. Manning, a ton of time. That line does a great job, and the catch is made at the 11-yard line. Burris juggled it for the moment, but was able to hold on. So Burris off to a big start tonight. Burris has now caught five passes for 84 yards. This good for 16.
Yeah, now this is a great job of pass protection here. I mean, they keep everyone off. They form a good pocket for Eli so that he can see, he can look up, and he can throw that in to Plexico Burris. That was a cover two deep safety, and I think if they had a single deep, I think they would have tried to get Plexico deep. If they have two deep, they try and get him on that deep end that they just did. But again, on either play, they have to have that type of protection. That was a perfect package, perfect pocket.
Reed Dowdy was the cover man, and that one is caught at the 7-yard line by Amani Toomer, the all-time leading receiver for the Giants, who gets tackled by Carlos Rogers. So eight passes have been completed by Manning tonight, five to Burris and one each to Moss, Smith, and now Toomer.
And we were talking, earlier how, he has so much confidence, Eli does now, and then I think after being a confident quarterback, you take that next step up to being comfortable in your confidence, and I think that's where he is right now.
Too tight, too wide. Play clock winding down on second and five. And Manning throws into traffic, and that was almost intercepted. Intended for Toomer. Too far in front of him, and Fred Smoot almost had the pick.
Yeah, and Eli Manning was telling him, keep going, keep going. He expected him to keep coming across, and Toomer, when he saw that he had inside coverage there, he kind of stopped and slowed up. And what Eli wanted him to do, when that guy sits inside you, just cut it off and run right across his face. Maybe you do need six preseason games.
So they got away with one. I don't think the Toomer needs six preseason games. Third down and five from the 7-yard line. From the gun. Taking too much time.
Delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty. It's third down.
Yeah, I think that was one of the things last year after mid-season towards the end that Tom Coughlin was really working with Eli on is to eliminate turnovers. Throw the ball away, throw it out of bounds. I've gotten this third down situation here. Okay, you have the field goal now. Try and get that touchdown, but if it's not there, throw it away. Don't force anything once you get in the red zone. Don't force anything anytime.
A third and nine. And Manning's going to throw it at the feet of Ward. So this bogs down the Giants after that opening drive went for the touchdown. I've seen their two subsequent drives bogged down. They got a field goal off the last one, and we'll have to settle for a shot at one here.
Yeah, watch Jason Taylor here. He feels it's a screen. And when he sees Derek Ward go to the outside, he stops his rush, turns, and goes towards Derek Ward. He was the guy that fouled up that play.
Carney at 44 again. Fiegel is the holder, and the punter is 42. Arp lives. Meanwhile, Rich Seibert goes off the field with a little bit of assistance. Slowly. There he is. Left guard. Carney now. Ready to attempt a 30-yarder to make it a 13-0 game, and all of a sudden, another penalty.
I would say that was on the Redskins. I mean, it looked like they had about five of the guys in the middle move.
Ed Hockley. Working out year round as always. Eddie Guns.
Encroachment, defense, nose guard. 5-yard penalty. It's still fourth down.
There was a nose guard and about four of his buddies, I think. Looked like an avalanche in the middle of that play. But it was a field goal situation before the penalty, and it's still a field goal situation.
Now a 25-yard attempt with the ball spotted at the 15-yard line. Manning and Moss going over things. Carney, 21st year in the league. Started with San Diego, then to New Orleans, Jacksonville, and KC last year, and the kick is good. 10:59 to play in the opening half on opening night. As you look at the Statue of Liberty, the Giants lead the Redskins 13-0.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies. For amber waves of grain.
For purple mountain majesties.
Above the fruited plain.
On June 1st, 2009, new document requirements will make getting home from Canada, Mexico, and the Caribbean by land or sea more efficient.
Now, isn't that beautiful, America?
Learn more about the Western Hemisphere Travel Initiative at getyouhome.gov.
Ground control to Major Tom. Commencing countdown, engines on. Check ignition and may God's love be with you. This is ground control to Major Tom. You've really made the grave.
This is Henry.
Daddy's home!
This is Edward. On Monday, October 13th.
I don't know any Edward. Who is Edward?
He is you.
Take the shot.
One man will discover he's living two very different lives.
You brainwashed me?
I didn't volunteer.
No, you didn't. But Edward did.
Christian Slater, My Own Worst Enemy, Monday, October 13th on NBC.
Jim Zorn, at the age of 55, making his head coaching debut in the NFL. When you talk about quarterbacks who became head coaches, Bart Starr, who was at Green Bay for several seasons, and Jim Zorn each threw 3,149 passes, the most NFL passes by players who became head coaches. So you go back through the years, and you had people like Norm Van Brockman and Bob Waterfield, but Starr and Zorn. And Cartwright will give them decent position, bringing it back up to the Redskin 36-yard line, where he's tackled by Michael Johnson. Here comes Campbell, John, and when you you look at Campbell and they're going to go to the West Coast offense, but tonight they're leaving the extra back in. It's almost as if they go back to Gibbs's style of putting the extra blockers in against the Giants attack.
Yeah, I think they kind of had to because they know that the Giants are going to blitz, so they're getting ready for the blitz, but they just have to get a better pace, they have to get in a rhythm, they have to get something going so they can build off that, because the Giants are just going to keep pressuring them.
Campbell looking to complete his first pass, and he does, but there's a penalty, so we'll wait to see if this one holds. And this is Chris Cooley, who had a Pro Bowl year last season. The tight end gets it to the 46-yard line, but the Giants are all signaling that the penalty will be against Washington, and all of the body language indicates that that's the case.
Yeah, we talk about the Giants and their defense and the pressure, and as Steve Spagnuolo said, if it works, I just keep doing it, and you can see that it has worked, and he's just keeping doing it.
There were fouls by both teams on the play. Number 60 offense, ineligible downfield, who is also holding defense number 97. The penalty's offset. Replay first down.
That's Chris Samuels and Matthias Kiwanuka, who are lining up facing each other.
Yeah, Kiwanuka was holding number 47, Chris Cooley. Yep, right there. Yep. He grabbed him by the back, threw him down. And then that's also the thing that got Cooley open, though, on that play. And then because the play got out of rhythm, Chris Samuels thought it should have been off, and he went downfield.
The human Uragon for the season, broken leg. Kiwanuka, as we stated before, back along the line. Now Portis puts his head down. He got poked in the eye earlier, but comes back in for this series. Up to the 40. You know, John, with Jim Zorn coming in and the West Coast offense, and it's all about timing and rhythm and all of that for Jason Campbell, another new system for him. The irony is, when you remember Jim Zorn as a player, he was a lot like Fran Tarkenton. He was the guy who loved to get out of the pocket and improvise.
Right, and he was a pain to play against because, you know, some quarterbacks you want to keep them on a spot like Jason Campbell. Jim Zorn, you didn't want to get him off the spot. But he was trouble.
Now Portis, and he'll be about a yard and a half short of the first down as Ross comes up, and Clark as well, and that's going to set up third down and one.
Yeah, you know, we were talking about how comfortable Eli Manning is, and I think that Jason Campbell is equally uncomfortable. You know, that in his last 8 years, college and pro, he's had seven different offensive coordinators, seven different systems, and seven different techniques. I mean, everyone wants him to do it a different way. And he has no comfort out there at all.
Ran a version of the West Coast at Auburn his senior year, and the Tigers were undefeated. And now on third and short, they give it to Portis, and he gets stacked up at the line of scrimmage. So on third and short, they run a very vanilla play, and it has no flavor.
Okay, here's the middle. This is where it all starts. Robbins, Cofield in the middle. Kiwanuka coming down from the outside. But it all starts in the middle. You see, there's no movement at all in the middle. And because that middle held the point, then that outside Matthias Kiwanuka kick it down and make that play.
Brooks making his NFL debut, already his fourth punt in the first 22 minutes of the game. And the corners makes the fair catch at the 14-yard line. Manning and the Giant offense back to work on opening night at the Meadowlands. 13-0, New York.
Coach Billy!
What? We need to open this Coors Light cooler for some Frost Brew refreshment. Do you know the combination?
Go double right, turbo right, double pump.
Coach, it's not working.
Tandem right, Z-peel, where's San Diego?
Forget it, Coach. I'm gonna wedge it open with a crowbar.
Let's wedge it.
I'm trying.
Frostbrewed Coors Light, official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Coach, we still can't get into the Coors Light. You're gonna have to come up here.
Time out.
He's coming.
Thank you.
No matter how different you are, you still got to appreciate a footlong Subway club. Piled high with flavor and still low fat. Subway. Eat fresh.
Mondays.
Hello, Claire.
Good will battle evil.
They're villains, Claire. They could destroy us all.
The Heroes premiere event, Monday, September 22nd on NBC.
Well, tonight's the opener, and then a lot of the rest of the league opens up on Sunday, our Sunday Night Football opener. Chicago going to Indianapolis. There's the gang, Bob and the boys. Coverage of Football Night in America starting at 7 Eastern time in the game at 8:15. From the 14-yard line, here come the Giants now, starting this drive with a Brandon Jacobs run over right tackle. London Fletcher in on the stop. Again, the Mannings are there, Archie and Olivia, and, you know, have two sons, each hoisting a Lombardi trophy within 365 days or roughly thereof of each other is off charts. Off the board.
Well, and you can just tell by meeting Peyton and Eli that they're two great parents, and I know them both, and I know that they are. And I know that's a fact.
Second and five. Here comes Jacobs again to the right side, and he does get taken down here by Jason Taylor. Nice stop there by Taylor. And there are the boys, the Mannings, going all the way back to their youth in New Orleans. They did meet here at the Meadowlands on opening night of the 2006 season, and last year on the left and the year before that on the right.
Not a lot of families have that picture, do they?
No, I don't think so.
And they both have the same look, the same angle, and I don't know, those were two special moments.
Third and three, 7 minutes to play in the opening half. Manning will convert, and that catch is made by Amani Toomer. His second catch of the game. Amani Toomer in his 13th year out of Michigan. He was drafted by the Giants number two in 1996.
See, the Redskins are trying to put the same pressure on the Giants, and they're bringing blitz and putting it, but the difference is Eli Manning is quicker. He's quicker with the ball. He's quicker with his release. He gets back, gets it out of there for the first down.
I'm right here.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line. Play clock at three. Jacobs. You know, Jacobs was at Auburn for a little while. He wound up going to Southern Illinois, started at Coffeyville, Kansas. He actually played on the same team with Jason Campbell for a year. We were talking to Campbell about him the other night. Campbell said, you know, the problem was we had so many good backs down there, they started talking about making him a linebacker and a safety, and he said, I'm out of here.
That's when he got out. He said he went to linebacker, to safety, then to tight end. He said, no, I'm a running back, and I'm going to be a running back, and I'm not going to stay here.
They run around Cornell Williams. They had a lot of great backs at that time. And the Southern Illinois went drafted in the fourth round in 04. Second down and seven. Here he goes to the left side. Matt turns the corner. Off he goes. Past midfield. That was Madison Hedgecock, the fullback, number 39, one of the best blocking fullbacks in the league. Michael Strahan can appreciate that one. It's a 24-yard gain for a first.
Yeah, here's Hedgecock making the lead and the block right there. And that's the one that springs Brandon Jacobs. This time, LaRon Landry gets over. Look at the difference between this tackle of LaRon Landry. He is not going to tackle this guy high again.
Landry already run over one time before as Derek Ward is in the backfield now. And it's caught by Burris, and he'll get spun down by Smoot with 4:40 to go in the half.
You know, we were talking earlier about Greg Blash telling his defensive backs, hit him low. If you don't, if you get him where you hit him above his waist, that's what's going to happen. So you see that power, and he just runs straight up. And if you are going to tackle him, you have to tackle him below his waist and maybe even below his knees.
Derek Ward now, and he will work his way. Keeps those legs turning for a first down. Again, behind Hedgecock. So part of that committee, and we've yet to see Ahmad Bradshaw, who's the other guy, and you know he can run. He had an 88-yarder against Buffalo last year, a key play in that game.
Yeah, we always talk about an offensive line working as a unit. Just from that shot there, you could just see this offensive line. They all get off together. They all get that push up the field, get the lead block there, the back right in behind them. This is an excellent, you know, I keep saying this, but this is an excellent run block offensive line.
Manning throws. Burris again. Big half for him. Smoot, who's playing a little bit more than he normally would. He would come in the nickel and dime, but with Sean Springs hurt, he's seeing a lot of action, and Burris is having a field day with him right now. That's 7 catches for 98 yards.
Yeah, Greg Bloss, the defensive coordinator of the Redskins, is trying everything. I mean, he's, you know, tried to zone him, tried to man him, tried to blitz him. He just can't get there. And even when he does have a free rusher, Eli Manning hangs in there and throws the ball for completion.
Second and 2 from the 26-yard line. Fake draw. Manning throws, and it's almost picked, and that's exactly what Washington would need at this point. Because they're getting eaten up. It's Carlos Rogers with the coverage on the play. Total yardage in this game right now. The Giants have 246 total yards, and we're not even at the half. The Redskins have 16. And the Redskins haven't completed a pass.
No, and part of that is the Redskins, remember their last two preseason games, they didn't look good at all, and they couldn't do anything. They just carried over into tonight's game. But another part of it, and a pretty big part of it, is that Giant defense.
The Redskins were outscored 71-6 in their last two preseason games. And this is Jacobs now on a third down play who gets bottled up. So again, the Giants with some good drives. The first one paid off with a touchdown, but now they're going to have to settle for a third field goal attempt.
I think when you get them going, you want to keep them going. Maybe they got a little conservative there.
Yep.
You know, because, I mean, Eli's throwing it. He's confident. And, you know, Plexico Burris can look like he can get open anytime he wants to. And, you know, I don't know that you have to do those kinds of plays, but... You know, again, you get the lead, and it's a regular season game. You're ahead 13-0. You get down closer. You just don't want to do anything stupid, maybe.
48-yard attempt coming up for Carney. Carney, you know, it's like a golfer who shoots his age. He outkicked his age right there. 44 years old, 48-yard field goal. 2-minute warning, 16-0.
Shoe Circus quality shoes at discount prices. Why pay more? Bill Gates.
Jerry Seinfeld?
Sure.
I'm good.
The left one's a little tight.
They'll stretch.
You sure they'll stretch?
Is that your toe?
No.
What is it?
Leather.
He's a conquistador. They run very tight. You get the other one.
You know what I do? I wear them in the shower.
You ever wear clothes in the shower, Bill?
Never.
You're dressed. And you're clean. Open the door, go about your business.
He's a 10.
10.
See how that feels.
Better.
That's a 10.
Es el conquistador.
Guess what, Bill? You're a 10.
Ellos van apretados.
Are you a Shoes Circus Clown Club member?
Platinum.
What do you get with that card?
Big top points.
You know, I imagine over the years you've mind-melded your Magnum Jupiter brain to those other Saturn ring brains at Microsoft.
I have.
Just wondering, are they ever going to come out with something that'll make our computers moist and chewy like cake so we could just eat them while we're working? If it's yes, give me a signal. Adjust your shorts. Oh, I knew it!
Samsung, the official HD TV of the NFL, brings you How I See It.
How do I see it? All the stats, all the numbers, all the accolades. I've had those. I've had great seasons. My whole perspective of the NFL changed after we won the Super Bowl, especially to win it in New York. 2 million people at our parade, key to the city, the fact that we did it together as a group and beaten one of the best teams. I mean, I can't really say too much about it. It was magical.
Tell us how you see it at Samsung.com.
It was the office ending we never saw coming.
You cheating on me?
When I specifically ask you not to?
Can't wait to see what happens next? Us either.
Messrs. Costas and Collinsworth are in the house. Bob and Chris, first half analysis, week one preview. Brian Williams will have a report from St. Paul, the final night of the Republican National Convention. So that's what's coming up on your Toyota. Breaks a tackle at the 20, and Cartwright into Giant territory, takes it all the way down to the 45-yard line where Kevin Dockery finally catches up with him. So Washington needing a spark and getting one on the run back. This kickoff special is being brought to you by Lincoln, introducing the all-new 2009 Lincoln MKS, Lincoln Retire. By Subway Restaurant, Subway Eat Fresh. By Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. And by Verizon Wireless. That was a 50-yard kickoff return for Rock Cartwright. The ball at the 45. Campbell still hasn't completed a pass. This time he gives it on a delay to Portis, and that's a 9-yard gain where he's tackled by the corner Aaron Ross.
I think this is a big drive here for the Redskins. You know, down 16-0, if they could just get something going, you know, just get something on the board, even if it's just a field goal. At least they have, you know, something to build on going in at halftime.
Campbell is 0-for-3. Portis has carried the ball 8 times for 33 yards. That was their longest play of the night, a 9-yard rush. Second and one. Campbell to the outside. Finally completes a pass to Antoine Randall L. So it took them 28 minutes and 50 seconds, and you saw Campbell say, let's huddle up here.
Well, you know that if he can get time, and the Giants bringing so much pressure that they have to be man-to-man in their pass coverage. So all you have to do is get the blitz picked up, and then what you have to do is get your receivers to get open and get some separation. And then you can make throws like that, because he did have the protection, and he did have that man covered.
At the 23-yard line, first down. Randall L in the slot, Moss outside. Portis is the running back. Flag is thrown.
Portis is smart on that. You know, we always think that if a flag is thrown and it's going to be a free play, you always think of a pass, but it, you know, that free play can be a run too, and you can, you know, everyone stops and you just keep going. Ed Hockley's.
There were two fouls by the defense. Offense, that, correct, I'm sorry.
And he's a lawyer.
Offside defense, that penalty is declined. There's also personal foul, face mask. That penalty is enforced half the distance to the goal, first down.
Objection overruled.
Well, this is what the Redskins needed. I mean, they needed a, you know, a play. They got it in their special teams in the kickoff return, and then they get protection and get a pass completion, get a penalty here, get good field position, you know, and get something going, get some momentum going into the halftime.
There is no such thing anymore as a 5-yard face mask. Well, they didn't even get the face mask. It's a 15 or nothing. There's no such thing as what we used to call the garden variety face mask. That wasn't even the garden variety.
No, that was a nothing that they cost him 15.
So it's first and 10 from just inside the 11-yard line. And the Giants moving around on defense, but it doesn't hurt them. There's a lot of action going on the other side of the line as Fred Robbins gets there first. Washington has all of its timeouts.
You know, you always hear about the defensive ends in this defense, but that Fred Robbins in the middle is a pretty good player. I mean, he holds the point when you try and run at him. He'll get penetration, and every once in a while he'll get a big pass rush right up the middle.
You're taking a lot of time in a situation where you have three timeouts. Down to 26 seconds on the snap on second and 11. Campbell's going to throw. It's going to be tipped, and it's incomplete, and it's out of bounds. But in this situation, you don't want to get into a into a situation where you're going to leave timeouts on the board when you've got three of them.
Right, and there's no reason to have to rush a play when you have three timeouts. I mean, they should have used one there, gathered themselves, and got the play. They were trying to hurry up too much, but you don't have to do that when you have three timeouts.
Well, they were hurrying up, but it still took them about 25 seconds to run that play. So now they're down to a third and 11. And they have more timeouts than they'll ever need here. Campbell.
Wide open.
Throwing wide open is Moss. And Santana Moss has gotten Washington back into the ballgame. That Rock Cartwright 50-yard return, the penalty, and then all of a sudden, the Giants completely dominant. But a point away now from a 9-point margin.
Right, there's Santana Moss. He started out on the left side, came all the way across, and again, that time, Jason Campbell had good protection. So he could wait for Moss to work his way across the field. Start on the left side, complete the pass on the right side.
45 yards, six plays. Sweezing the point after. Brooks is the new holder since he won the job from Frost. And the kick is good. So a near perfect first half by the Giants, and all of a sudden it's a 9-point game, 16-7, with 13 ticks left in the half.
Touch it, bring it, fade, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop all that. Feel it, curl it, find it, view it, code it, jump and lock it. Technology. Technology.
What do people think of pasta from Pizza Hut?
That's good.
This is delicious.
They can't get enough of Toscani pastas from Pizza Hut. Choose from new premium bacon mac and cheese, meaty marinara, or creamy chicken Alfredo. 3 pounds delivered with breadsticks for $12.99. Now get pasta from Pizza Hut.
Transformers.
What is that?
In high definition. For the first time on Blu-ray disc. Transformers. Own it on Blu-ray High Def today.
Kick. A 30-yard field goal attempt to try to win it. Ball down. Kick on the way. It is good. It's good. It's good. And that's it.
Live from your pocket, it's the NFL. Get the new NFL Mobile Live free with any data plan. Only from Sprint. Only on the Now Network.
Tomorrow night, it's a football and musical celebration when Usher and Keith Urban perform in the NFL kickoff special on NBC. Then Sunday night is football night when the Colts host the Bears.
A Super Bowl rematch.
Wow! Only on NBC.
A new season of Heroes begins with a three-hour premiere event. Monday, September the 22nd. I jumped the gun on the promo, John. What can I tell you? Out of format. Bouncing ball. Bobbled, recovered up at the 30-yard line by Kevin Booth. By the way, John, Heroes, a new season will begin Monday, September the 22nd.
There you go. I just heard that somewhere.
Double promo. I was just rehearsing it. Good show, big hit. Coming your way in a couple of weeks. Giants Stadium in East Rutherford. One more season here, and across the parking lot, the Giants and Jets will go to the new digs.
I was really surprised how close it was. Yeah. You know, as you look at the building, it's darn near touching this one.
About halfway finished with construction as the Giants leave the field with a 16-7 halftime margin. So Bob and Chris with the first half analysis, Brian Williams with a live report from the Republican National Convention. Coming up, but first, these messages from your local NBC station.
Welcome to kickoff weekend in the National Football League.
I've been waiting all year for this.
Go Rams.
Go Packers.
Go Chicago Bears.
Go Chiefs.
Go Buffalo.
And at the Meadowlands, as we come back to start the second half, it's been Go Giants. who had a 16-0 lead, and then the Redskins were able to get on the board in the last minute. 9-point lead. Andrea Kramer down on the field. You've spoken to both coaches, and what did they have to say, Andrea?
Well, understandably, Jim Zorn very frustrated with this team's offensive performance, but he told me Jason Campbell has to read the defense, not just pick one receiver and stick with him, and he cannot be intimidated by the Giants' pass rush. He was encouraged by the touchdown at the end of the half, but as for Plexico Burress running free, he said they've got to double their coverage, but that is reliant on getting a pass rush going. As for Tom Coughlin, frustrated, very angry, he said our kickoff coverage is lousy. We can't continue to give them the ball at midfield.
And he's angry because they had a 16-0 lead and were dominating, and that Rock Cartwright run back put Washington in a position to score. Meanwhile, Campbell is 2 out of 6 for 25 yards. Talking about Burress, and Burress running free, 7 catches, 98 yards, John.
I think maybe it even started a little before that for Tom Coughlin. I felt when they had the ball and they had the 13-0 lead that maybe they got a little satisfied, maybe they got a little conservative, and then they got that 16, and then they get the run back, and all those things happen. So I don't know that it just happened on the kickoff. I think maybe, you know, the play, a little let down on offense, a little conservative on offense, then those other things happen.
Yeah, I think he's a little frustrated with the fact that they had a near perfect opening drive, and then they had 3 pretty good drives going, and they just bogged down, and they had to set up a Kearney field goal.
Right, and they had them down. I mean, they had the Redskins down, and the Redskins didn't have much life or weren't showing much life, and then they gave them life right at the end of the half, and now we'll see if they can carry that over.
And Washington will get the ball as we start the second half. One new rule change this year, by the way, on the coin toss, as in college, you can defer. In other words, get your choice to start the second half. That wasn't the case tonight. The Giants won the toss, elected to receive, and so the Redskins get the second half kickoff. John Kearney will send it toward the south end zone. Here's Rock Cartwright. He of that 50-yard return before the half, and this time he is taken down with a flag thrown. Jairus Wilkinson, Giant outside backer.
Personal foul. Illegal block below the waist by the kicking team, number 53. 15-yard penalty. Washington keeps the ball. First down.
You know, that's usually the wedge buster. You see the wedge here, and if you come down and you go below the knees on the wedge, which they did right there, that's a penalty, and that's where that cutting comes in on the coverage team.
Ryan Keel, rookie out of BYU. So.
Yeah, and that's one of those things that, you know, that if you're going to take on the wedge, by rule, you have to take on the wedge high, and that's not a very good deal sometimes.
He's being reminded of that right now.
Yeah, but if you take it on too high, you come out looking out your ear hole.
From the 34-yard line. Going straight up the middle is Clinton Portis. Gain of 3. Good start for the Giants tonight. An 11-play, 84-yard drive. Manning scoring the 3rd touchdown of his career. Brandon Jacobs, the big bull, for 11 carries, 74 yards. Burress, a big first half. 7 receptions for 98 yards. And then it was Moss who was able to get into the end zone for Washington at the end after they didn't even have a first down until late in the half, apart from a penalty. And here is Kiwanuka swallowing Portis up.
Well, you better, if you're going to run to the right away from Kiwanuka, you better keep him backside and block him backside. In fact, Cooley is trying to do that, but he just beats him to the spot. I mean, there's a lot of guys that you can run away from and you don't have to block him on the backside. Kiwanuka is one of those guys that you better block on that backside. You know, the first guy that is that way that I can remember is Lawrence Taylor. I mean, you know, sometimes they'd put 2 on Lawrence Taylor when they would run away from him.
3rd and 8, Giants with 6 DBs, and we're dying here. Campbell out of the shotgun. Pressure from the outside. Kiwanuka gets there, but he gets the pass away. And Moss is able to come up with the ball, but he was tackled. He loses his helmet, and Corey Webster with the coverage on the play. The Giants are saying no. One official came in and said yes. The reception was good, but the tackle was made, and that will be short of the first down if indeed they rule it a reception.
And he led him right into Corey Webster, who was playing a zone. You lead it away from one guy in the zone and lead him to the other. Here he is right here. And you see he's going to run it out.
Pass is complete. Fourth down.
You see Corey Webster came off. He was zoning. He came off and he took away that out. And a good tackle to stop getting the first down.
Even though Webster thought it was an incomplete pass, walking away as if it wasn't even complete.
Now Santana Moss knew it was complete, but he didn't know where Webster came from. Now he thought he had man coverage and he was running away from man, but he was running into a zone.
Durant Brooks, rookie out of Georgia Tech, with a floating, wobbly kick that has backspin on it. And it's fielded at the 26-yard line by Webster, who takes it back up to about the 28. So the Giants on offense for the first time in the half when we come back, 16-7.
You can settle down. You can fire it up. You can tune it in. But it's still not summer until you bring it out. Introducing Bud Light Lime. It's the superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor. One taste and you'll find the summer state of mind, it's in the lime. Bud Light Lime.
Turbo HD from Dish Network is the complete high definition experience.
Frank, imagine if you will, me. In three dimensions.
No, not 3D, high def, HD.
Whatever. A picture's so good, it's like I'm actually in your home. You could reach out and touch me. Go on, try to touch me.
I'd rather not.
How about a hug?
No.
This is awkward.
Get Turbo HD by Dish Network, the 100% HD service. Plus, get HBO and Stars free for 3 months.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on GMC Sierra with better highway fuel efficiency than a Toyota Tundra. And right now, you can get a Sierra 1500 extended cab starting at just $20,488. Offer ends September 30th.
The division itself is comprised of four teams that love to hate each other.
And one thing you'll find out in the NFC East is it's a physical game. You know, each and every time you step on that field against each other, there's no love.
It's kind of like the heavyweight division in boxing.
Good way to describe it. New York, Philadelphia, Washington, and Dallas in the NFC East. The Giants have the ball at the 28-yard line. Brandon Jacobs is the running back, lined up behind Hedgecock, the fullback, who provides the leverage as Jacobs then takes it to the 30, only for a gain of 2, making it second down and 8 for New York.
Montgomery and Fletcher.
Joe Bugel, long-time assistant coach, and he was the head man at Oakland and Arizona. Coached the Hogs through the years, the offensive
right,
line.
He's coaching the running game here. In fact, we mentioned this before, but when Jim Zorn came, he brought the West Coast offense passing game, but kept the same running game for the Redskins. And Joe Bugel, the offensive line coach, is the guy that installs the running game.
Manning stepping up, moving forward, hits Jacobs, complete, just short of the first down. And it will be third down and 1. Fletcher and Doughty in on the stop.
I wonder if Doughty's enjoying this.
I doubt it.
But he gets there. He's that second guy, too. I mean, you see the pattern. He runs a check through. Then he goes out to the left. Now watch him finish off Doughty there. Doughty is coming into him. Watch. When he ends up, he is turned the other way. He's trying to grab his head and can't find him.
He's playing in the heavyweight division, but he's a welterweight next to this guy. Third and 1. Jacobs again, and he has enough to pick up the first down before Fletcher falls on top of him. That'll move the change, and the Giants have a first down at their own 39-yard line.
You know, one of the things that has impressed me is that Jason Taylor is playing as much as he did. He was out here in the pregame, and you know they didn't know it was going to be a game-time decision. They didn't know if he was going to play or not. He tried a brace on, took the brace off, and I don't think he's even playing with a knee brace tonight.
Well, here he is. He's got a tape job, if nothing else. He lines up over McKenzie. On first half from the 39-yard line.
This is a tough thing for him. I mean, he's naturally a right defensive end playing left defensive end.
They just do get the playoff, and the pass is wobbly and deflected and incomplete. Carlos Rogers, number 22, as Manning just did get the snap off before the play clock expired and almost has it picked.
I think the Redskins are saying, if that's what you're going to do to us, if you're going to bring the pressure, you're going to bring the blitz, we're going to bring the blitz on you. And that time they made Eli throw the ball where he didn't have an open guy. I don't know if Plexico Burris was ready for it, or I mean, he sure wasn't open, and he didn't have much else to go to.
Second down and 10. Two more left, Burris right. Drifting. Back across the middle, and that's incomplete. So Washington able to put enough pressure on Hedgecock, the intended receiver, and it'll be third down.
You know, Kareem McKenzie, the right tackle here, 67, has been doing a good job of staying with Jason Taylor. You know, he's done a good job of a run blocking, but also pass protection.
Manning, tremendous on third down against the Patriots back in February. And tonight, very effective. Five attempts, four first downs on third down passes. Here he is again trying to convert on a third and 10, and this time he can't. So all of a sudden the Redskin defense looks a lot different at the outset of the second half, intended for Smith, and the Giants will punt for the first time in the game.
Right, and the Giant offense doesn't have that same pace. And again, I think they lost it just before the end of the first half, and they haven't gotten it back.
Jeff Fiegel's his 21st year in the league. He was the oldest player in the league until they signed Carney the other day. So at the age of 42, Fiegel's sending it to the corner with a directional kick, and that will go out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Redskins with the ball, Giants with the lead, 16-7.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on GMC Acadia with better highway fuel efficiency than a Honda Pilot. And right now, you can get an Acadia starting at just $27,162. Offer ends September 30th.
Hello?
We are watching you.
Who is this?
Follow directions, you'll live through this. Disobey, and you die.
Someone is pulling your strings. Find out what is happening.
Jump. Jump now. You are required to complete the task.
Go, go, go!
Compliance is vital.
How are you seeing us right now?
We are everywhere.
Eagle Eye. Rated PG-13. September 26th.
Distance with a team lamp, or design your own customized NFL team apparel. Personalized right down to the name, colors, and number. It's authentic NFL, and it's available only at NFLshop.com.
Henry. Edward. One man. Two lives. Christian Slater. My own worst enemy. Monday, October 13th on NBC.
Back at the Meadowlands, Al Michaels, John Madden, Andrea Kramer, opening night of the season, 16-7, the Giants on top. 10:06 remaining here in the third quarter. And the Redskins take possession at the 14 on first down. Portis, big hole, big run. And Portis, who led the league in carries last season, is all the way out to the 37-yard line behind Randy Thomas, pulling and leading the way. And for Clinton Portis, out to his own 39, a 22-yard gain.
Right, here's Randy Thomas right there. He's a right guard. He pulls to the left. He comes and kicks out. Portis cuts off it and then cuts back. The play was going to be a kick out on the left side. He didn't get all the way to his puller, and then he just kept cutting back.
They give it to him again, and it gets taken down as he goes through the middle. Brian Keel making the stop. Very often, you don't see the player not lecturing the coach, but telling.
Well, he's coaching the coach.
Yeah, he's coaching what he's doing.
He said, "Here's what we can do. This is what their defense is doing, and I think we can get this on him." And then they come back with two Portis runs in a row.
And Zorn was a willing listener. Second and six. Campbell stepping up with that good shoulder move. And that buys time. And then he goes deep downfield, and it's almost intercepted by Aaron Ross with brilliant coverage on Santana Moss.
Yeah, that's when you really know you're a cover guy, or you really have to be a cover guy when a quarterback has this much time. And can you have to cover all the moves? It's a stop and go. It's still not there. It's still not there. Still not there. Oh, here it is. That is coverage. That's being on an island. That's staying with your guy the whole time and making a play in the ball at the end.
Third and six. Up at the 41-yard line. And that is caught by the rookie Devin Thomas. But he stopped shy on the first down. They picked him in the second round out of Michigan State. He was their top draft choice. They traded their number one pick. Big receiver, 6'1", 220, out of Michigan State, makes his first pro catch.
Now again, the Giants are bringing their pressure, and they're coming right from that left side, and they make him get rid of the ball, but Devin Thomas still should have gotten up and gotten the first down. He should have known where the first down marker was. He could have taken another step or two and still caught that pass for a first down.
Brooks wearing out his leg tonight. Fair catch call for made at the 19-yard line by McWhorters. 7:59 to play in the third. Scoreless second half to this point. Giants on top by nine.
Academy Award winner Robert De Niro and Academy Award winner Al Pacino.
Who made the decision to enter at that time?
I did.
Whose decision was it?
Mine.
The two greatest actors of a generation.
About an inch of daylight between them.
They're like Lennon and McCartney.
The movie event we've been waiting for.
Am I a suspect here, Lieutenant?
If you don't back him, you will regret it.
I need to know who I can count on.
From the writer of Inside Men.
Whatever happens, I'm not taking it down with me.
Righteous Kill. Rated R. Starts September 12th.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Buick Enclave with better fuel efficiency than Acura MDX. And right now, you can get a Buick Enclave starting at just $29,950. Offer ends September 30th.
I, Brian Urlacher, challenge thee to an honor duel.
What?
An honor duel.
That was me, Brian Urlacher. And I started using Swagger from Old Spice. Who's laughing now? Me.
After two straight playoff victories, B.J. Singh has the cup in his sights. But Sergio Garcia and Jim Furyk are close behind. Who will be the next champion? The PGA Tour playoffs for the FedEx Cup continue with the BMW Championship. Saturday on NBC.
Coming this fall, one man discovers he's living two very different lives. Christian Slater, starring in My Own Worst Enemy. It premieres here on NBC on Monday night, the 13th of October. Now from the 20-yard line before the first snap, we already have action up front with Seibert.
Ball start, offense, number 69, five-yard penalty, first down.
Rich Apier out of Western Illinois, as we mentioned before, the Giants with the same five offensive linemen starting every game last season.
Yeah, tough guys. Five tough guys, and probably the best of the bunch is the right guard, Chris Snee. You know, the Giants only had one player last year in the Pro Bowl, O.C. Uemura. And I think that this next year they're going to have some more of these guys go to the Pro Bowl.
On first down and 15, and that catch is made over the 29-yard line by Plaxico Burress. You know, one reason, John, is they do the Pro Bowl voting before the end of the regular season. When the last time we saw the Giants here on a Sunday night, they had lost to Washington 22-10. They looked like they were dead. They had to go to Buffalo the next week in a windstorm, fell behind 14-0, but won that game, then came back, and despite losing to the Patriots, played that magnificent game that night, and into the playoffs they went.
To me, that was where it all started for the Giants, in that last regular season game against the Patriots and the way they played them.
Jacobs on a second and one with a gain of about 16 before Andre Carter, the defensive end, runs down the field to tackle him from behind.
Yeah, I was just talking about Chris Snee, and in the play before, he had a good pass protection. Right here, he just gets on his guy and he just stays with him. I mean, he makes good contact there and then finishes. Stays with him, holds a little maybe, and lets Brandon Jacobs get by. But, you know, I mean, these guys not only control the line of scrimmage, they dominate the line of scrimmage.
Rolling left against the grain. Manning throwing downfield, and that's going to be picked off at the 36-yard line by Fred Smoot. So he overshoots the receiver. Andre Carter that time put the pressure on Manning and hits him as he threw it, intended for Kevin Boss and intercepted by Fred Smoot.
That was a big play by Andre Carter, 99. You see, they're trying to bootleg or get around him. He gets out here and he puts the pressure on Eli. Not only the pressure, but he put the hit on Eli just as he was throwing the ball. But on that play on a bootleg, you try and fool that defensive end. You try and get him to follow the run to the right, and then you bootleg around him on the left. That one didn't fool Andre Carter.
Carter's been to the rodeo before. Big play.
He was the guy that made it.
6.5 to go in the third from the 36-yard line now. We'll start this with Clinton Portis chugging through the middle for a gain of 3. Eli barking at himself. Manning last year, 20 interceptions during the regular season, tied for second most in the league, but only one in the 4 postseason games. Actually, was tied for the league lead in picks at 20 last year.
And again, this is one thing the Giants have really been dominating the Redskins. You let them hang in there. And then you give them a kickoff return, and you give them another play here, and pretty soon they're back in this game.
Portis, 41-yard line. Washington on the ground tonight. I mean, through the air, Campbell has only attempted 9 passes, and they've run the ball 17 times.
You know, we're talking about Kiwanuka, but watch Justin Tuck in the way he makes this play here. I mean, he starts up the field, sees that it's not coming to the outside, and then folds underneath and makes the play. They could help Jason Campbell out here, Jim Zorn could, by letting him throw on second down instead of this situation.
3rd and 5, deep drop, steps up, throws, completes it, but well short of the first down. Needed 5, got about 2. Kiwanuka smacks Portis to the turf, and the frustration right there on the face of Clinton.
Watch Portis the way he chips, though. I mean, he is a tough guy. Watch him right there. I mean, now when you draw up a chip block, that is a chip block. Watch that. Boom. I mean, that's just unloading, decleating, and putting the guy flat on his back. That's why I love Clinton Portis.
Picked by Brooks. The Porter's at the 14-yard line, and the coverage is perfect. Racing down the field was Rock Cartwright to make the tackle. Still a 9-point game.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Pontiac G6 with better combined fuel efficiency than Honda Accord. And right now, you can get a G6 sedan starting at just $16,720. Offer ends September 30th.
In the search for love, always remember, dating is a contact sport.
I'm ready to work!
Dane Cook, Kate Hudson, Alec Baldwin, and Jason Biggs, My Best Friend's Girl. Rated R, September 19th.
Introducing Bud Light Lime. The superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor.
This is my family. This is their new HD TV.
That doesn't look like HD.
I don't think it's hooked up right.
And this is me. Yeah. Let's see what happens this time when my family goes to Best Buy.
This LG's perfect for you, and Geek Squad can set it up.
I don't know what HD is, but I don't like it.
No interest for 3 years on all home theater purchases, $9.99 and up. Best Buy. You happier.
Three average people with one thing in common. Talent. TV's number one show continues its search for the best act in America.
Don't let go of this dream.
America's Got Talent three-night event starts Tuesday on NBC.
You can log on to NBCSports.com or NFL.com, and that's what the screen will look like on Sunday Night Football Extra. Live coverage of the game, replays and stats, even your own camera angles. Sunday Night Football Extra. From the 13-yard line, a first down for the New York Giants in a scoreless second half. Derek Ward is the running back. Manning hands the ball to Ward, picks up two. Second down, 8. We go to Andrea.
Well, guys, it's very humid down here and about 80 degrees, only 7 degrees cooler since the start of the game. And Giants cornerback Corey Webster had some cramps, so they took him in the locker room for an IV, and they're just watching both sidelines because it continues to get very hot and humid down here.
It was 87 at game time, I think 90 in Manhattan today as the maximum temperature, so a hot night in the Apple is reflected on that pan.
Well, you know, these guys, they play like a quarter in preseason games, and then the regular season breaks out and they have to play the whole game.
Second down and 8, that'll be a gain of 7 for Ward as he goes to the middle. Up to the 23-yard line, it'll be third down and 1 for the Giants.
And, you know, they roll in the running backs, and they roll in the receivers, and they, you know, change the tight ends. But I've been talking about these offensive lines. You know, that's one group that they don't. And, you know, and you say, if we have to, you know, substitute every other position and roll again, why don't we roll offensive linemen? Offensive linemen are the type of guys that you just let them play, and you don't even look at them. You don't even look.
And normally, teams only carry 7, so you have 2 subs, maybe an 8, as opposed to the defensive line, where sometimes they carry as many as 9. Third and 1. And that is caught by Steve Smith, who makes the catch. And that'll be a first down. Under 3 minutes to play now in the third quarter.
I mean, Steve Smith has become a big, you know, a big first down guy. I mean, he just knows how to run patterns. And Eli was talking about him the other day, that he can run those inside, those slot patterns, those option patterns. And you can see here, he just has a feeling as an outside receiver to get up enough where you get that first down, and then if the ball is completed, you know, have you enough yardage for the first down.
Played at U.S. during the regular season a lot, but really came on when he got healthy in the playoffs. And that pass is caught by Ward. Ward is out of bounds at about the 37-yard line, covered on the play by Smoot. And a flag is down. And we also have a player now. We have Fred Smoot, who's hurt. So already banged up in the secondary, and Smoot writhing in pain.
If you undo the buttons, loosen the screws, shake off the ropes, baby, ain't nothing gonna knock you down.
Hey.
I found like this CD just lying in the locker.
What is it?
What is it?
Yes.
The raw intelligence.
The CIA needs it.
Get us a reward.
That's fantastic.
The Russians want it.
The Russians?
Why the Russians?
That's just a taste.
PC or Mac?
But on September 12th,
we don't really know what anyone is after.
Not really, sir.
Everyone's gonna get it.
But appearances can be deceptive.
Burn After Reading, rated R, starts September 12th.
They were ordinary people who discovered extraordinary abilities.
It wouldn't be like this if they'd never known about us.
On September 22nd.
All these powers.
Some choose to be heroes.
What do you want from me?
Some villains.
What's your power?
You have no idea the fire that you're playing.
Destroy everything.
I'm starting to wonder if I'm even human.
Good will battle evil.
I can fix all of this.
The Heroes premiere event, Monday, September 22nd on NBC.
This NFL kickoff special is being brought to you by the GMC Sierra, the official vehicle of the NFL, by Bud Light Lime, the drinkability of Bud Light with 100% natural lime flavor. And tonight's telecast is presented in high definition by Turbo HD by Dish Network, the only 100% HD service. That is from the East Village on 12th Street. You will find Irresistible Mac and Cheese. Fred Smoot, who went down in a lot of agony before he went to the commercial and took a shot and was rubbing his lower left back, is able to get up and come off the field.
You can see right here as he goes down, he grabs his back right there. And now they lose Smoot and Sean Springs. Remember when we talked to him last night? They thought he was going to start, and then he's not even dressed tonight. So Carlos Rogers, our other corner, is coming off a knee surgery. Sean Springs isn't active. Fred Smoot limps off the field.
The safety, LaRon Landry, didn't play at all. And you look at Springs, and now they're going to go to Lee Torrance, third year out of Stanford.
This is a great down, second and two. This is when you can do anything. It's an excellent play-action pass down.
Baptism by fire for Torrance. There he is, top of the screen. One-on-one with Burris, and beginning to back off as Eli will hand the ball off, and this is Ward who will pick up the first down. So they settle for a conservative play call up to the 41-yard line, under 2 minutes now to play in the quarter.
Yeah, because when your offensive line kind of has control the way this Giant offensive line does, you're not worried about leaving third down out there. So if you want to take a shot, you know, second and short is a pretty good time to take that shot.
Kevin Gilbride on the mic into Eli's helmet. First and 10 from the 40-yard line. Off the screen and goes over the middle and hits Burris. That time Burris lining up on the other side. Some coverage by Dowdy and the linebacker McIntosh. Now a minute to play in the third. As far as the Giants stars tonight, they're the numbers for Manning. 16 out of 30. Jacobs is averaging a stellar 6.6. And Burris, who just recently started practicing full time, 9 receptions for 120 yards. Big night.
It makes it look easy, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Flexco Burris.
Second down and one from the 48. And Manning will throw the ball out in the flat, and that'll be a first down to Hedgecock. And John, we saw him a lot last year. We were amazed that a guy who wouldn't practice all week, and he couldn't practice because of knee and ankle injuries, could be so effective.
Yeah, and he just has a feel for the game. He has a feel for getting open. What they've been doing now, if it's a cover two, if they have two deep safeties, he's running the in and the hook. And then if they go single safety, he's running the out patterns and the fades. And whatever they play, the Giants have an answer for him with Plexico Burris.
No scoring in the third quarter. It remains 16-7 Giants after three. And this NFL kickoff special from the Meadowlands will continue after these messages from your local NBC station.
You may be wondering what this has to do with the new season of Chuck. But does it really matter what it means? Yeah, we didn't think so either.
Who's your mom?
Chuck returns Monday, September 29th to NBC.
The Engineers of Death Magnetic. Metallica. Live. January 31st and February 1st. Prudential Center. American Express card members only. Get your premium ticket package this Monday, September 8th at 10 a.m. through Tuesday, September 9th at 10 p.m. before the general public. Order at Ticketmaster.com. Package includes Metallica's new CD, Death Magnetic, in-store September 12th. Plus, a free download of the show you attend with each ticket purchased. Metallica. Performing as part of the American Express concert series.
Dames en heren, we gaan beginnen!
Exceptionally brewed for a taste that's pure Amsterdam. Amstel Light, one damn good beer.
Congratulations, Mr. Manning. You are now a Toyota owner. So,
that was a chest bump. You want to do it again?
No, no. The moment's passed.
Now's a great time to sign. Because right now at your Toyota dealer, you can lease a new 2009 Toyota Camry for just $199 a month. Toyota, official vehicle of the New York Giants.
People say I need my head examined to be riding to work, but I like the sense of freedom, just like with my docs. I got the top heart guy on the west side, this amazing nutritionist on the east, and last year when I threw up my back, I found the best guy right on my block in Brooklyn. In fact, I can choose from the best docs anywhere in the city. Whoa! You want to get your eyes checked, man.
Music's biggest names perform for free at 11.
Fourth quarter. We start the final quarter at the Meadowlands. Al Michaels, John Madden, and Andrew Kramer. First and 10 as the Giants have the ball just inside Washington territory. And breaking through is LaRon Landry along with Andre Carter. So the safety and the end combined for the sack as you see Smoot going back to the locker room.
Yeah, we were just talking about that. And when Eli Manning of the Giants see man coverage, and you're going to get man coverage when you get a blitz like this, he's trying to go outside to Plexico Burress. He looks out there, Burress has coverage, and then the rush gets to him. Andre Carter coming from that right side. Tom Coughlin the other day, the guy that he was worried about on this Redskin defense was Andre Carter. He said he gives David Deal problems each time.
Carter, eighth year, when they played with the 49ers. The pass out here is caught by Amani Toomer, who's taken down at the 46-yard line. It was a second and 18, and it'll be third down and 9, and there goes Smoot again with Springs out and Smoot out. There's a penalty flag thrown on the last play as well.
It's at the 43.
Ed Hockley with the call in a moment.
Illegal shift offense. Two backs were moving at the same time. They didn't come set for a full second. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
So then the game's a 9-yard gain. Update on Smoot. Let's go to Andrea.
Well, we saw Fred Smoot get kneed in the back. He was very, very much in pain, walking gingerly. They're calling it a hip corner. They tried to put him on the bike to loosen it up, but he was just in so much pain, they took him in the locker room for further examination. They're calling his return questionable.
One thing about playing in a Thursday night game, at least you have a few extra days to heal. So Smoot will have until the 14th, a week from Sunday, when the Saints go to Washington. Second down and 23. As Manning throws over the middle and wide open and making the catch is Ward, and Ward gets the ball back into Washington territory to the 46-yard line, and that'll set up a third down and 10.
Yeah, we were talking about Andre Carter and kind of being a rushing problem over here. Watch what they do now. They're going to have Kevin Voss. They line him up over on that side, and they have him chip on Carter. Then they have Deal waiting there to pick him up. So, you know, when you're having problems with a guy and you want to settle him down, that's a pretty good way to do it.
Third and 10 from the shotgun. Four down linemen. Three-man rush, eight back, and the pass is a little too high for Burrish to pull down. Landry moves over to the safety spot for the coverage. So fourth and 10.
Yeah, there's going to be a guy that's going to be a superstar in this league, Laron Landry. I mean, he has great speed. He's a tough guy. He's a hitter. He has, you know, great range. He can make plays on the ball, and I think before it's all over for this guy, he's going to be a very, very special NFL player.
Well, the DeJuan plays for the Baltimore Ravens. Picked by Fields as a line drive, fielded by Antoine Randall at the 11-yard line, and he cannot get around the corner. The coverage is great. The Giants take him down back at the 9-yard line. The Big Apple on this hot Thursday night. Giants up 16-7.
Week 5, 2007. Giants on the brink of going 2-3, knocking on mediocrity's door. But then Eli connects on a 53-yard touchdown pass, and you
probably missed it because you only get 4 games on cable.
There's only one way to get every game every Sunday. NFL Sunday Ticket, only from DirecTV. So who's Eli gonna pump fake into submission this season? Your mom?
Switch now and get 4 months of our best TV package for free.
The day begins the same as it has every day for over 130 years. With generations of brewmasters still hand-selecting the finest hops and 2- and 6-row barley. With a stubborn commitment to an age-old recipe, which costs so much to brew and age. It's a tradition of quality we'll always stand by. Some things aren't meant to change. Some things never will.
This message approved by Toyota Corolla. For over 40 years, Corolla has been relied upon to deliver excellence, boldly shaping America's automotive landscape. Its popularity in the hearts and minds of millions have solidified its reputation for quality and high MPG. Year after year, look to Corolla for legendary long-term dependability. Trusty, faithful, 35 MPG rated. Toyota Corolla, the solid choice for 09. This message approved by Toyota Corolla.
This is on the road leading to Giants Stadium. Perhaps you've heard. And in the catacombs of Giants Stadium, there's the locker in the Jets locker room. The Jets, by the way, used to train on Long Island, and they just moved last week to their new digs over here in Jersey as Clinton Portis takes the ball up to the 14-yard line. He's tackled there by Ronaldo Wynn, number 99.
Ronaldo Wynn is in there for Justin Tuck now, and that's one of the interesting things. If they can get Wynn to play that position, then Tuck can still move around and get some of those, you know, drop some of those inside pressures and a lot of the things that he did last year.
Second and 5. Portis able to stay on his feet and turn nothing into a little bit of something as Wynn is again in on the tackle, and Clinton will set up a 3rd down and 1 as we tick down to 12 minutes remaining in regulation in a game in which the Giants were dominant in the first half but bogged down on 3 drives, settled for field goals. It was 16-0, and Washington got back in it with a last-minute score. In a scoreless second half, 3rd and 1, Washington comes up in a tight formation with only Moss split to the left.
Jason Campbell's changing the play here. He sees them all packed in there.
And he's going to give it to Portis, and they're going to get the 1st down as he lined up alongside Mike Sellers, the fullback. And that'll move the chains. The ball is out to the 23-yard line. By the 27th birthday, there are the numbers that some of the big men have put up through the years. Emmett, who was the all-time leading rusher anyway, is the leader right there. Portis would be fifth on that all-time list. His 27th birthday was 3 days ago. From the 22-yard line. Rolling. And then thrown to the sideline and incomplete, intended for Antoine Randall in front of the Washington bench. It'll be second down and 10.
Yeah, I think that's what Jim Zorn was trying to do, is get some running game going and making the Giants play run defense and then give them play action or bootleg and get Jason Campbell out. But I don't feel Jason Campbell has gotten into any rhythm. I mean, not only in this game, but we saw him twice in the preseason, and I know those things are hard to tell, but he just doesn't have this offense down yet.
5 of 11 for 40 yards. Second and 10, and the whistle here. And that's another false start.
Offense, number 82. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Second false start charge to Randall L. tonight. When you look at, well, there's Zorn showing his exasperation.
Well, I would too. I mean, I don't mean to jump in here, but I mean, you know, a wide receiver should never be offside. I mean, you know, they could look in at the ball. They don't have to be first off. They don't have a big nose tackle over them that's going to pop them. There is no excuse for a wide receiver to be moving and jumping.
Twice.
And he's lined up way out here. All he has to do is look in. If he can't hear or doesn't remember the count, just look in at the snap.
Second and 15. Screen. And it's deflected and incomplete. It's too high. Intended for Betts. And Campbell now 5 out of 12. The thing about Campbell, too, we haven't pointed out tonight, he is coming off, as you see, a little skirmish here. It's the NFC East. What else is new? Campbell coming off as you look again here. There's Pierce, and it would figure Antonio, an ex-Redskin, would get into it. With Pete Kendall, an ex-Jet.
Ooh, that's dangerous when you lose your hat. As long as you got your hat on, you see, they can punch in the face, you don't get anything. Now when the hat's off, now you have a face that is punchable. I'm surprised there's not a penalty on that.
Ooh.
They were grabbing face masks and then punching
him. And then he headbutts him with his helmet.
Right, and they just let it go. They don't care.
Third and 15. And that's caught by Randall L., but he put him in trouble to begin with and can't extricate them, as he can only get it up to the 26-yard line, and that'll force another Brooks punt.
You know, that last situation is one of those, Al, that there was no penalties called, but there will be fines for. You watch next Friday, you'll hear, you know, fined in that game or, you know, the following.
Pretty hard to miss on the tape.
Yeah.
Seventh punt for Durant Brooks. Good one. Fielded at the 21 by R.W. McQuarters. And a nice run back as McQuarters takes it back up to the 35-yard line. 54-yard boot. Giants and the Redskins. It's happened before.
This salad is really good. You want a bite?
No, thank you. I'm a meatitarian.
A what?
A meatitarian. I only eat meat, beef, bacon. You know, meatitarian.
Oh.
It's a personal choice. You have to commit to it, you know?
The Wendy's Baconator. Six strips of hickory smoked bacon on two quarter-pound patties of fresh, never-frozen beef. It's way better than fast food. It's Wendy's. Have a way better shake way later. Enjoy a hand-spun frosty shake late at night.
Good cop.
Give up the wallet, man.
Scared the hell out of me.
Isn't it?
Bad neighbor.
The outside lights shining right into our upstairs.
See how that could be annoying.
On September 19th.
What the hell are you doing?
You didn't ask my permission to plant these trees. Come on over. Let's do something.
Who can you call?
Get off my property.
I'm gonna call the cops. Tell you who's on duty.
When you can't call the police.
He's trying to kill us. Oh!
Lakeview Terrace. Rated PG-13.
The sun was out. The weather was great. And I got to hang out with Santana Moss.
Good job. Good job. Gotta shuffle. Just push it.
Get those feet! Can I buy those off you?
Turn around.
Let's go, Allie, let's go!
Santana says it's important for kids to get outside and play so we can grow up healthy and strong.
I'm Santana Moss. Helping kids stay active and healthy is how I live United.
Want to help? Go to liveunited.org.
This kickoff special is being brought to you by Wendy's. It's way better than fast food. It's Wendy's. By DirecTV. Now get over 130 of your favorite channels in HD. And by Toyota, moving forward. Here are the Giants now at their 35-yard line. This drive commences with a Brandon Jacobs foray over left, over right tackle for a gain of one up to the 36-yard line. Setting up a second down and nine.
Now the Redskins have made pretty good adjustments, I think, to the Giant run. I mean, they've kind of calmed it down a little.
Trying to calm down the hit pointer for Smoot. He comes out of the locker room and back onto the field, but not onto the field of play yet, still on the sideline. Second down and nine at the 36-yard line.
Eli Manning identifying the mic.
In the pocket, throws. Burris makes the catch. And Plaxico Burris now into double figures tonight, making his 10th catch of the game, good for 133 yards.
Doesn't it look sometimes like Plaxico Burris is just out there running around against someone in the park? I mean, the guy's up there playing tight coverage on him, and he still runs a hook on him. I mean, he's so big and so strong that he can do that. You know, you say that you can't run a hook pattern against press coverage. He just did it. And then because he's bigger, stronger, and he just knows how to play the game.
Ties his career high with 10 catches. 8:45 to go in the fourth. Jacobs again. Jacobs to the 45-yard line.
And we look at Brandon Jacobs tonight, and we just look at that power, and his power really comes at the end when he finishes off runs great. Then when you think he's going to run over you, he gives you a little move like that and runs right by you. So you think, you know, you think it's going to be power, you think he's always going to bully you, you're going to, you know, brace for that hit. The minute you brace for that hit, he'll give you a little move and go around you.
Well, he's juked and burrowed his way and bulldozed his way to 100 yards tonight on 16 carries. So in the triple figures, and he adds a couple more here as he seeks the first down and appears to have it at the 42-yard line, and does.
Yeah, I was saying that the, you know, Eli Manning looks so much more comfortable this year, and the two things that'll make you comfortable as a quarterback is a good run game, a good runner, and a good offensive line.
Good coaching.
What a difference a year makes, yeah. Though, huh?
Amazing how much smarter Tom Coughlin became last year, right? 42-yard line, first down, halfway through the fourth quarter. Manning guns it over the middle, and that one's deflected. That time, Burris had double coverage. LaRon Landry and Rogers both there, incomplete.
Well, LaRon Landry left the deep guy, and I think that's what had been happening, is he'd been, you know, deep. He'd been that deep middle safety, and he'd been going off, and then they've been running him off. But right now, you're going to see he's not going to go with the deep guy. He's just looking all the way at Plaxico Burris. He's just going to take that away. He's not worried about someone going deep from the other side. He'd look and turn to Plaxico Burris.
Second and 10 from the 43. Jacobs again. You know, we looked at Coughlin under the gun last year, John. But, you know, we've watched him through the years, all the years at Jacksonville, and he started that franchise from scratch, and then over here. And, you know, people who don't know him, they see him, and of course he's intense. But the one thing about Coughlin's teams for all of the years, always disciplined, always ready to play. His clock management is terrific. You don't put anything over on Tom Coughlin.
No, and pro football is a very intense game. And it has to be in coach. It has to be coached intensely, and it has to be played intensely. And with a lot of passion, and that's what he brings to the game.
Third and 7. And Manning's going to go down, so a big sack here. The ball loose, but after the whistle, and that is Chris Wilson, who would be number 3 on the depth chart at end, at defensive end behind Erasmus James and Carter.
And he's one of those guys that's going to do a spin move. Watch here. Here's Chris Snee here, and he's going to get him going to the outside. Then he's going to spin and go to the outside again, and then he gets away from Snee, and he's straight up on Eli Manning. Started to go to the inside. Snee kind of went to the inside, then he stuck to the outside.
Big sack on third down play with time starting to become an issue right now in a 9-point game. And that kick will take a very good bounce for the Giants, not bouncing into the end zone. Instead, it'll be down at the 9-yard line. Washington starting deep in its own territory. A little more than six to play. 16-7.
Kick. A 30-yard field goal attempt to try to win it. Ball down. Kick on the way. It is good. It's good. It's good. And that's it.
Live from your pocket, it's the NFL. Get the new NFL Mobile Live free with any data plan. Only from Sprint. Only on the Now Network.
Introducing Bud Light Lime. The superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor.
Tomorrow, don't miss the last great action movie of the summer. Nicolas Cage.
My name's Joe. This is what I do.
Bangkok Dangerous. Star in theaters tomorrow.
Truckers say if you can haul 10,300 pounds, you darn well better be able to stop 10,300 pounds. This Tundra's four oversized disc brakes don't mess around. Its beefed up engine takes care of the rest. Looks like man's got a new best friend. Available on the full-size Tundra. The truck that's changing it all.
Wednesday, September 24th, we're changing an American icon from the inside out.
Transformation complete.
The premiere of Knight Rider, Wednesday, September 24th on NBC.
Tonight's show tonight, Howie Mandel is on, so is Olympic gold medalist Sonia Richards. Tomorrow, Eva Mendez, and next week, Michael Phelps will be visiting Jay on the Tonight Show. Sonia Richards, by the way, who won the gold in the 4x400 relay and the bronze in the women's 400-meter run, is engaged to Aaron Ross, the Giants cornerback.
And she was at practice the other day. I was out there and I met her. Very impressive.
Here's Cornish taken down at the 7.
Yep, there's a penalty. But she had her medals with her. She had a gold medal and a bronze medal. And that was the first time I've ever seen one. And she was impressive, and the medals were impressive.
She's on the Tonight Show tonight. I love the way she calls her fiancé Ross.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness defense, number 59. Late hit, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Yeah, that's a carryover. I think he meant 58, Al. That was a carryover from that last series, remember? Remember Antonio Pierce? And he was going through it over there. Watch him now. He's 58 right here. Here he comes. Play is over. Portis is down. Still going for him.
And then here comes Wilkinson. He called 59. Wilkinson came in to the pile late as well. From the 22-yard line on first down. This is Justin Tuck. They touched Portis away. Good night. Tucked them in.
This is the thing that Justin Tuck does so well is he'll take the inside. See, they're trying to block him there with Chris Cooley, and Justin Tuck just goes right inside him. And not only does he go inside, but when he goes inside, he goes in with real strength and power.
Second down, 13 now. Clock ticking down, 5:20 to go in the fourth. Campbell from the gun. Here comes Tuck. They pick him up. Pass is caught by Antoine Randall-L. And Randall-L gets out near midfield to the 44-yard line, where he's tackled by the rookie safety Kenny Phillips. That's a gain of 26.
They finally took advantage of that blitz, and you're going to see the Giants coming to blitz, and then they had that zone dog in behind it, and it gets Randall L right up the middle. And that's what the Redskins need now. I mean, they need plays in big chunks. And maybe pretty soon they may start thinking of going no huddle here, too.
Sellers stayed in to make a nice block that time as Randall L makes the catch, but then falls down. And they'll spot it at the 46-yard line with 4.5 to go. It'll be a gain of 2, second down and 8.
And now I think they get to the point where, you know, they have to speed up things, you know, get the ball up the field more. We're getting very close to a point where running the ball is not going to make a lot of sense anymore.
Second and 9. Off the fake to the outside. And this is the first catch of the game for Chris Cooley, the Pro Bowl tight end. His first catch of the season. And that takes the ball to the 48-yard line, but still short of the first down. Third and 2.
Again, and when you need two scores, you know, you always talk about the 2-minute offense you go and do when you need one. We're in a 4-minute offense now. They have to speed it up. They're taking way too much time.
More alacrity is necessary. And remember, Zorn's coaching his first ever game as a head coach. Hasn't even called the plays before. He was the quarterback's coach in Seattle. Remember how wasteful they were at the end of the first half, even though they wound up getting a touchdown. And then through the middle. And busting his way for a first down is Portis, and that'll take it to the 39, and it will take the clock down toward the 3-minute mark. Redskins have all of their timeouts.
And this is probably one of the problems with, you know, the first game and a new system is you don't have your no huddle yet, but they should definitely be in no huddle.
They'll snap this one with under 3 minutes to go. It's Portis again. In a two-possession game like this, you go either way, of course. You can get into field goal range and get the 3. And then, well, then you have the choice of either onside kicking it or having your 3 timeouts and hoping your defense does the job or seek the touchdown. Meanwhile, there's an injury timeout, an injury stoppage here with 2:39 remaining in the fourth quarter. Robbins.
Can I get a little help here? Hello.
Hey. We all upgraded to Verizon Wireless. Got push to talk and the reliability of the network. That old service is useless now. Careful. Cement.
Don't be the last one standing with another push to talk. Switch to the only one that comes with the network. Activate push to talk on 5 business lines to get these great deals. Verizon Wireless.
All around the world, men with erectile dysfunction have taken 36-hour Cialis. Today, men can also be ready with another dosing option, Cialis for daily use, a clinically proven low-dose tablet you take every day, so you can be ready anytime the moment is right.
Tell your doctor about your medical condition and all medications, and ask if you're healthy enough for sexual activity. Don't take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, stop taking Cialis and call your doctor right away.
36-hour Cialis or Cialis for daily use. Ask your doctor if a Cialis option is right for you, so when the moment is right, you can be ready.
Meet Henry, average guy. Meet Edward, a highly trained operative. One man, two very different lives, and they don't even know it. Christian Slater, My Own Worst Enemy, October 13th on NBC.
Aerial coverage brought to you tonight by Gillette Body Wash. Robbins goes off the field. He got hurt. Jay Alford comes in. It is second down and 7 now as play resumes with Campbell having time, throwing over the middle, checking down, hitting Portis. Flag is thrown. For the moment, it's a first down at the 29-yard line, but a flag is down back in the offensive backfield, and it looks like it's an offensive holding call here coming up from Buckley.
Offense number 60. 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
The left tackle, Chris Samuels. Go back to the roughing call right now where Pierce came in, and initially it looked like Pierce was going to get flagged, but watch Wilkinson come in after Pierce.
Yeah, 59, thought, and there's your call. I thought it was against Pierce, and then after Pierce did what he did, here comes Jairus Wilkinson, and look what Tom Coughlin thought of that play.
How stupid can you be? Don't even need subtitles. Second and 17.
First thing the Redskins have to do here is get back in field goal range.
And that's dropped. Moss took his eyes off it. Coming right into him, right into his hands. Third and 17.
That was one of those where, you know, I don't think it was looking, you know, like you were to get, you're going to get hit, but he's trying to make a play. I mean, he's trying to look for, you know, get the ball, make the next move so that he could take it up the field, not run into that safety and make a bigger play. This is a big play for the Redskins here. They need a play that will get them in field goal range.
Moss's second drop tonight. On third and 17, they have to get to the 30 for a first down, and instead they throw it way underneath to Santana Moss. I mean, you've got to go downfield. You can't throw a swing out in the flat with 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go and leave yourself with a fourth and forever out of field goal range. But they do, and then they have to take a timeout on top of it.
Hi, what can I get for a dollar?
That's yours.
How far can I get with this?
You can get out.
How tan can I get for this? That's it. Hi. What can I get for this?
How about two sizzling 100% pure beef patties with all the amenities and an irresistible classic known fondly as the double cheeseburger? Huh?
Wow.
Now more than ever, McDonald's dollar menu.
If you undo the buttons, loosen the screws, shake off the ropes, baby, ain't nothing gonna knock you down.
What if every ATM was free? No more $2, $3 fees. No more paying to access your own money. It'd be like every ATM in the world was your ATM. The Schwab Bank High Yield Investor Checking Account. Zero ATM fees, a great interest rate, no minimums. And it's FDIC insured. The Schwab Bank High Yield Investor Checking Account. The biggest thing in checking since checks. Open an account at 1-800-4-SCHWAB or schwab.com.
Fourth and 13 coming up. The Giants tonight, hot start. And who would have figured after that opening drive that would be their only touchdown of the night? It looked like they were on their way to scoring about 40. Since then, 8 drives, 3 field goals for 9 points, and that's it. Meanwhile, the Redskins only 6 points over their last 2 preseason games. Burrs has had a big night, and now we come back to a 4th down and 13 from the 43-yard line. Campbell buying time, shoots it to the outside, and then staying in bounds but not able to pick up the first down is Liddell Betts. And that will take us to the 2-minute warning, or close enough. Well, actually, it's a change of possession, which is a minor break for the Redskins here because they'll stop the clock after the Giants' first play. But they're still down by 9.
You know, and that was one of the things that Jason Campbell knew, that he couldn't throw to the short guy, and he tried not to. I mean, he was trying to look upfield, trying to buy time, trying to go, and then at the end he had no one else to go to. You see, he's looking upfield, trying to get something up there. He didn't want to have to do this.
Now the Giants will try to run the clock out, even though it's going to stop 3 times. It'll stop after this play for the 2-minute warning, and then the Redskins will have 2 timeouts. And they give it to Jacobs. And that's our 2-minute warning. with the ball at the 35-yard line, coming with a minute and 57 to play on opening night of the 2008 season. The Giants up by 9.
This message approved by Toyota Corolla. For over 40 years, Corolla has been relied upon to deliver excellence, boldly shaping America's automotive landscape. Its popularity in the hearts and minds of millions have solidified its reputation for quality and high MPG. Year after year, look to Corolla for legendary long-term dependability. Trusty, faithful, 35 MPG rated. Toyota Corolla, the solid choice for 09. This message approved by Toyota Corolla.
I was an intelligence analyst in the U.S. Army.
Warrant officer with the 18th Airborne Corps.
82nd Airborne.
Green Beret.
91 Echo, dental assistant.
Chemical officer, and I served in Iraq.
The Army taught me how to be a team player.
To be decisive.
I learned how to be a leader.
To be strong mentally
and emotionally.
As it turns out, camouflage is a great way to get noticed. 150 careers in the strength America's top employers are looking for.
I am Army strong.
I am Army strong.
See what it's like at GoArmy.com.
On December 19th, 1983, Hector Negron killed a man. In his New York home, they found a priceless Italian artifact.
What's it doing buried in the bottom of your closet?
It was a clue to a mystery that began in World War II. From Spike Lee, the director of Inside Man.
I know. I'm the only one left who knows.
Miracle at St. Anna, rated R. The mystery arrives in theaters September 26th.
Monday, Aaron Rodgers makes his debut against Adrian Peterson and the Vikings. Then the Broncos take on the Raiders. ESPN Monday Night Football returns with a special doubleheader starting Monday at 7.
As soon as the game is over, we'll hand it off to Brian Williams in St. Paul for the John McCain address to the Republican National Convention. This is in 2008, right here on NBC. Immediately following the game, which right now has a minute and 57 on the clock, and the Giants have a second down and 7 from the 35. The Redskins with 2 timeouts. Jacobs bobbled it. A stop man for a gain of 1. The Skins will take their timeout right here, and we will have upcoming a third down and 6. Funny game, John, in the sense, you know, the way the Giants started out, that first drive and then the second drive looked good before it bogged down, and I thought we'd have a big rout on our hands. And instead, even though the Redskins are trying to get back into the game, I mean, the Giants have always had control of it.
Yeah, the Redskins' offense just never did get any rhythm going, you know, and they, you know, if they could have gotten something going, maybe have to throw a little more on first down or some of those kinds of things, but they couldn't get anything going, I think. Their defense adjusted pretty well to the Giants' offense, and I think they kind of slowed the run down a little. They couldn't handle Plexico Burris, but they handled the rest of the passing.
Now third and 5, the Redskins defense compelled to stop Jacob Shy on the first down here, and look at him going sideways and close to a first down, and even before the measurement, Washington's going to have to take a timeout.
Well, and the key word is there, they have to take the timeout.
They couldn't afford to let any more time, and Ed Hockley's going to stop it anyway. To measure.
Look at what he does to a pile, though. I mean, he just puts his head down and just keeps his feet going, and he's so big and strong, and as long as he keeps those feet going and those legs moving, you know, he's picking up 4 or 5 yards after he hit the initial pile.
And they're going to be a couple of inches shy of the first down.
And I think you still have to punt it. You know, I mean, it's easy. You know, say it's only a couple inches. But I think in this situation, you have to punt the ball.
You do, because otherwise you're giving them the ball in a situation where if they get one first down and kick a field goal and then recover an onside kick, they still have a good chance or a decent chance to win the game. This way, You don't afford them that opportunity and make them have 2 relatively long drives.
I was going to say, I don't think the decision is final yet, though.
It looks like they're remaining.
Well, it's interesting. Washington, because of the measurement, is not charged, and that is in the rule, as Tom Coughlin now is exercised over this.
Washington has elected to use their final timeout. It's a 30-second timeout.
They use it here. In other words, if you call a timeout before a measurement, you can get that back if they call a timeout or a measurement, which they did. But then when the measurement went in Washington's favor, which it did, they would wind the clock here the minute the ball is ready for play. So Washington still must use its timeout.
Right, so they had to use that, but they'll pick up another one here at change of possession. Once they return this punt, the clock will stop again because of change of possession.
Right.
And then they have to again get the ball, get it in field goal range, you know, kick a field goal in an onside kick and so on. That's how they're still in this game.
Without a timeout. Jeff Fiegel is to punt. And he'll angle that one toward the far side, and it's a very short kick. And that will be spotted at the 33-yard line. So the Redskins, without a timeout in a two-possession game, needing a field goal and a touchdown.
Yeah, I think somewhere, you know, I mean, it's awfully late, and I've been thinking this, you know, for the last quarter, but somewhere you have to get Chris Cooley involved in this. I mean, he's your big guy. He's a star player in this league, and he's caught like one pass for 7 yards.
Exactly one.
And, you know, I mean, I thought this in the last drive. You know, you have to, you know, find something for Cooley because, you know, he should be a go-to guy in these kinds of situations. They have him split out here now.
Split wide to the right. Dockery is on him. Campbell's looking the other way. Campbell throwing to the outside. It's caught by Randall L. And Randall L. will get out of bounds after a gain of 9 up to the 42-yard line.
You know, that's one of the problems with this West Coast pass offense is when you get down and you're against the clock, you don't have a lot of deep passing. Everything is kind of, you know, quick rhythm, get the ball out of your hands, get it to your receiver, let him run. But at some point, you have to chuck it deep.
For the most part, their West Coast has gone south tonight. Second and one. Up the field he goes. That is caught in Giant territory by Moss. No timeouts. They got to get up. Either spike the ball or run it without a huddle. A minute and 11, a minute 10, and ticking down. Campbell comes up in the shotgun from the 47-yard line. Over the middle again, and the Giants will give them all the 6 and 7 and 8 yard dink and dunks they want as Randall L. makes the catch at the 39-yard line with 54 seconds to play. And ticking down.
You not only have to get it deep or try and take a shot deep, but you have to get it to the outside.
Campbell. Now he's going deep. Down the right sideline, and it's incomplete, intended for James Thrash, with Kevin Dockery with him step for step. Thrash, 12th year in the league, their number 3 receiver.
Right, and if that's a guy that you want to go after, it's Kevin Dockery, is you want to get that jump ball. Kevin Dockery is only 5'8". So if you could get a deep ball and get a jump ball, you ought to win it against him in that situation.
Third down and 2 from the 40-yard line. Campbell. And that pass is thrown out of bounds. So it'll be fourth down. And they're down to having to at least get the first down to have any sort of a chance. Thrash, the intended receiver there. That would have been a first down, obviously, but he threw it on the chalk.
You see, Thrash was a little close to the sideline. I mean, part of that was Campbell throwing it too wide, and part of it was Thrash not giving his quarterback space to the sideline between where he's running the pattern and the boundary.
Fourth and 2. To the outside, and they can't get out of bounds. They get the first down, but that's worth about 4 cents.
I think they have to kill the clock and kick a field goal.
Absolutely. Randall L. makes the catch. Kill the clock, kick a field goal, they get an onside kick, and even here, they're taking too much time. That was an extra, like, 4 or 5 seconds before it was even spiked.
And they're not going to try the field goal. I think that's the play that you have to do because it's really your only chance to win.
Well, John, as a former coach, you go back to camp this next week. And you do work on the hurry up, don't you?
Oh, yeah, they have to. I mean, they have to spend time on that. They have to get their passing game in a rhythm. You have to work on your 2 minute, your no huddle. You have to work on your 4 minute. You have to work on all those situations.
Second down and 10 from the 32-yard line. Going to the end zone. And it is incomplete, intended for Moss. Double coverage on the play as Corey Webster got back there to get a hand on it.
He had a shot there. If he throws it outside, if he throws it instead of bringing him back to the inside, if he throws it outside to the pylon, he could have had a shot at that.
Well, the game is over, but we know a few of our friends are watching rather intently here. 9-point game, 7 seconds to play. Campbell, flag is thrown, and that is caught by Betts, and he'll get slimmed down at the 11. And if the penalty is on the Washington Redskins, that will be the end of the game. In the meantime, Mathias Kiwanuka is doubled over. Samuels held him and
tackled
him. However,
the time expired. Therefore, the foul is not enforced. The play is not, the game is not extended. The game is over.
Yes, it's an offensive foul, so the game is over. But in the meantime, you've got Samuels who hogties Kiwanuka. Mathias has gotten up. Ooh, and he went down very awkwardly, clutching his left leg. Remember, he broke his leg last year and missed the last several games of the season. So the Giants score early, but not often, win the game by a score of 16-7. And we move to Indianapolis, where we will see you on Sunday night. Al Michaels, John Madden, Andrea Kramer, our entire crew, saying good night from the Meadowlands.